It's no secret the Bobcats and the Grizzlies don't like each other much. Throw in national rankings, a Big Sky Conference championship, plus playoff positions, and an in-state rivalry turns into a national showcase of FCS powerhouses. The regular season comes down to this one game, the Brawl of the Wild. And it's next on Scripps Sports.
From Scripps Sports, this is Big Sky Conference Football, Montana State at Montana.
It may be a frigid day in Missoula, Montana, but it certainly doesn't feel that way with how heated these teams and fan bases are today heading into what is being dubbed the biggest edition of the Brawl of the Wild. This year, it's much more than just bragging rights for the next 364 days as number 4 Montana State and number 3 Montana battle it out. And on this final day of the regular season, so much on the line, the first ever top 5 CACRIS battle with an outright conference crown up for grabs. You could not have written this script any better as we welcome you high above Washington-Grizzly Stadium, everyone, alongside the former Montana State and Montana defensive coordinator Ty Gregorek, as well as the former Montana QB and Hall of Famer Marty Mortingwig. I'm Ben Creighton. Kyle Hansen and Scott Breen will also join us down from the field coming up in just a couple minutes. Marty, I'll begin with you. With this being basically the Big Sky Championship game, Montana looks for an even bigger performance today from the quarterback in Clifton McDowell.
Well, they're going to need one from McDowell. He's got strength, he's got speed, he can also throw the ball, he's got a little electricity in him. He's going to need a big one, Ben. Also, Eli Gilman, this man has breaking tackle ability, big time. He's also got speed. They may need a couple of big plays from Eli Gilman. And then Braxton Hill is the team leader on defense. This man can run sideline to sideline. He's a superstar, and he likes to hit people.
Definitely one of the top tacklers in all of the Big Sky this season in Braxton Hill. And that's going to be the big matchup we'll keep an eye on for this game is Montana's rush defense right now. The tops in the Big Sky Conference right now. You see the numbers right there. Meanwhile, for Montana State, the top rushing team in the Big Sky, one of the best in the entire country. And Ty, when you look at that Montana State offense, it all begins with their two quarterback system in Tommy Milan and Sean Chambers.
No question. It's not the starting quarterback and the backup quarterback. It's QB1. And QB1A. With Tommy Milat, you've got a guy that's 17-3 as a starter. When he gets on the perimeter, he's flat, dangerous, and hard to bring down. With Sean Chambers, you got a guy that touched the ball 9 times last week and scored 5 touchdowns all in the first half. These two are electric. The offense runs through them. And then as we go to defense, you've got a senior captain, linebacker Nolan Askelson out of Billings, Montana, who is an extension of the coaches. He gets everybody lined up. He's been in the system a long, long time. And then the cowboy from Millstone, Montana, Brody Grebe. What a junior year this guy is having. He plays with great effort and hustle. He's got great get off. Opposing quarterbacks do not love to see number 10 across the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Brody Grebe, a part of a stout D-line for this Montana State crew. Well, we got these two guys up here in the booth. We also got two guys down on the sidelines in Kyle Hansen as well as Scott Breen as we go down on the field first with Kyle. What's up, Kyle?
Ben, Ty, Marty, great to be here with you guys on the biggest day of the year for sports in the state of Montana. And what a weather day we have here for November football in Missoula. So let's go ahead and take a quick check at our Stockman Bank weather report for today's game. 40 degrees here in Missoula and foggy this morning heading into the game as it was all week. Only 4-mile-an-hour winds. And compared to last year's Brawl of the Wild, which was historically cold, we have very pleasant conditions as we get ready for the Brawl of the Wild. So that's a look at today's weather, sponsored by Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking. Well, last week at the conclusion of the Portland State game, we had a chance to talk with Bobby Houck about Montana being in a position to win another Big Sky title and going up against their rival, and he kept it simple. He said that feels, quote, normal. And they're trying to do that again for the first time since Houck was here in his first stint, and of course, adds us even bigger stakes to this rivalry game. But that'll do it for me here on the Montana sideline. Let's send it over to my partner on the other side in Scott Breen. Scott?
Yeah, thanks, Kyle. You know what? If this game is as close as it is expected to be, the big intangible for Montana State may very well be special teams. Brendan Hall has a booming leg. The 6'9" punter really neutralizes the return game. He has 66 touchbacks this season. You can't really even run the ball back once he kicks off. They also lead the nation in net punt yards. Bobcats did make a change at place kicker, bringing in Butte freshman Casey Kautzman just a couple weeks ago. That'll do it from down here on the sidelines. It's smoke-filled as the Grizzlies take the field. We'll send it back upstairs to you guys.
All right, Scott, appreciate it. You see Montana State's head coach Brent Vegan right there looking for another win in this Brawl of the Wild rivalry. Of course, a tremendous tenure so far out in Bozeman. The fastest start in program history for a head coach at 32-7. Just off to a terrific start in his tenure in Bozeman. And, you know, Marty, I want to get your thoughts on this really quickly. You've played in so many of these games, so you know every single year these players are absolutely juiced up to play in this game. But like I said before, with this being the Big Sky Championship game, you got to imagine there's some extra adrenaline running in these guys today.
There's going to be some white foam coming out of some of these young players' mouths. They need to focus on what their assignment is. Trust the teammates around them, trust the game plan, trust what your mama says, and then go out there and play with some passion.
And Ty, obviously you coached in so many of these games on both sidelines. What makes this rivalry so special?
Well, Ben, I think with everything going on at the FBS level and all the movement and conference realigning, rivalries are dying, and that's sad across the landscape of college football. This rivalry, which is now being played for the 122nd time, it ain't dying. It's just getting better and better and better. And everyone's talking about how it may be the biggest ever. They're all big, Ben, but yeah, 3-4 with everything on the line. How lucky we are to get to call it today.
Yeah, the Grizzlies will get the ball to start this one. You see Brendan Hall right there. Scott just said it a second ago. Has been excellent this season on kickoffs as well as punts. You see Junior Bergen right there back to return for Montana, as well as Garrett Graves for the Grizz. Like I said before, you could not have written a better script for the 122nd edition of the Brawl of the Wild. A Big Sky title, bragging rights, and playoff positions on the line as we are underway here at Washington-Grizzly Stadium, as that will fly into the end zone for a touchback. So the Grizz offense will start from the 25. And Marty, like we talked about in the open, Clifton McDowell, I mean, ever since he basically took full reins of this Grizz offense, this Montana team offensively, I mean, they have been clicking.
Yeah, let's not be surprised, because Montana State and Montana's, both their defenses saying, we have to stop the run. That Montana and Montana State offenses may very well put the ball up in the air just a tick more than we might expect going into the game.
In this six-game winning streak, they've averaged 441 yards per game. The first give to Eli Gilman, gets past the 25 and taken down for a gain of 4 right there. So taking a look at the players to watch here this afternoon, sponsored by Achieve Montana, college savings for their future. We talk about the running game, Marty, a second ago. Nick Osmo, also impressive in that backfield. Junior Bergen, also solid in the wide receiver core.
Nick Osmo's a tackle breaker. Bergen, special teams player and a heck of a receiver.
And Ty, I know how much you love to talk about Rylan Orton and that secondary for Montana State.
Well, yeah, and he's from right down the street, Sentinel High School. He's a Missoula guy. He has progressed amazingly this fall, no question. And Bobcat Nation is going to be thrilled to see on that first play, Ben, number 30. That linebacker, Danny Hughes, back in the lineup. That's a huge, huge key for this MSU defense.
Nice play from him. McDowell was trying to hit Bergen on a quick slant. And what a great play by the Montana State defense. Gets us to a third and long here, Ben.
Yeah, third down and 7 here for the Grizz offense, as Blake Stillwell was the man in coverage there for Montana State. Dow this season, 59% completion percentage, over 1,100 yards through the air. He'll look to go here and finds a wide open target in Aaron Fonts. And the Grizz move the sticks.
That's a nice job moving in the pocket by McDowell. It is a big plus for the Montana Grizzlies to have Aaron Fonts back in the lineup after injury. That's a nice grab by Aaron Fonts, sort of on the back eye up high.
Yeah, Montana State just brought a three-man rush there. You could say, you could tell McDowell just kind of gave that flinch that pulled Nolan Askus a little bit, hit it right over the zone over the top of him.
Going underneath this time to their tight end and Evan Schaefer, and he gets near midfield. And yeah, you mentioned Clifton McDowell, a lot of time in that pocket, and that's the big thing with QB1. He's getting more and more comfortable in that pocket. But again, he can also scoot out of the pocket and use his legs.
Yeah, good accuracy on that one. You see Montana is throwing the ball a little bit more than everybody expected. Why? Because Montana State is a very good run defense.
Play fake, McDowell. Busting up the gut, and another first down for the Grizz offense as they get into Montana State territory.
Yeah, defense coordinator Willie MacGarza brought some weak side pressure there with Ryland Orton, who we were just talking about. It's a nice job by McDowell, kind of feeling it, stepping up in the pocket, avoids Ryland Orton. Great job by him moving the chains, first down Grizz.
Again, a very balanced attack. On the slant, going to Keelan White.
That was a back-to-back RPOs. The first RPO, McDowell pulled it, and his receiver wasn't there, so he had to run it. This time, you can see, he's reading that flat defender. The flat defender plays the run. He throws it outside for a nice completion.
Montana offense continuing to march down the field on their opening drive. Eli Gilman trying to bounce to the outside, sheds a couple tackles, still on his feet, and finally brought down for a gain of one.
Eli Gilman can break some tackles. However, it looks like Montana State has an awful lot of population around the football.
Yeah, this front four for the Bobcat defense. So you can see Blake Schmidt right there, point of attack. And something Coach, you and I were talking about. These guys, it doesn't matter which side of the ball, they have to wrap up and swarm tackle against these two fantastic rushing offenses.
Yeah, like you mentioned, we talk so much about the defense for Montana. Montana State's also impressive. Second in the Big Sky in rushing defense. Gilman, again, bouncing off a couple tackles and belted out of bounds.
This is some great football being played. That was a read option, and Gilman got the football and broke a bunch of tackles, but this Montana State defense looks like they've got 12 players playing out there. There's so many people around the ball.
Well, see, that's the offensive guy and coach, and this defensive guy, I'm saying, that's a lot of missed tackles. They need to clean that up if they want to compete against the number three team in the country.
Yeah, again, you see the numbers. Eli Gilman, one of the top rushers in the Big Sky, also leads all of FCS freshman yards per game. Pressure coming. McDowell escapes with the time running out, but able to make something out of nothing.
Well, it's great pressure here, and this is what Montana State, they've got so much depth at D-line. So they bring in a couple backup defenders. This is Kenny Iden out of Bozeman, Montana, number 11. He just makes a miss. Great job by him. And again, a lot of missed tackles in this early drive for Montana State's defense.
That's...
Yeah, again, Clifton McDowell. I mean, he's been fantastic, like we talked about, the last six games. And even going back to last week against Portland State, he averaged 9 yards per carry. So again, he can really scoot. This time going to Nick Osmo, and a shoestring tackle near the 15.
You can see that Montana is dressing it up, a little eye candy. They went quads into the boundary and just ran tight zone. And there was a gaping hole there. That looks like a positive for Montana's offense.
Out of the pistol, back to Osmo. A couple yards short of that first down marker. As Montana is in the AVA red zone for the first time this afternoon, you see the numbers. 78% near the bottom of the Big Sky, and looking to produce here on their opening drive.
Well, Montana's 2 for 2 on third downs alone in this first drive. This is the biggest third down of the game up to date right here because they're in scoring range.
And you're seeing a lot of this formation, guys. This two backfield, that's actually a tight end in the backfield, kind of a 20 personnel look, but it's not.
Clifton McDowell again, lost the football. And it will be Montana State football. So you talk about a big turnover on the opening drive with Montana driving down the field.
Well, Coach just said it. Biggest third down of the game thus far. The kid fights, he's fighting, and sometimes fighting for those extra yards isn't always the best thing. Turns the ball over, we'll see how the refs decide here.
That's Montana State's ball. What wins games other than points scored and points given up? The biggest statistic that correlates directly to winning is the turnover ratio. Both of these teams are really good regarding turnover ratio.
The play is under review.
Well, it's definitely a fumble. I mean, he's up.
Well, that's the thing right there. That's what Montana's saying. It should be their football.
This is going to be fascinating.
But it will be close.
On what the replay booth is going to end up saying here. Because that was a heck of a first down by McDowell. McDowell needs to keep the football high and tight, the 5 points of ball security, all of those things. He's really got to focus in, especially in a game like this, especially down tight in
After
the red zone.
After reviewing the play, Montana recovered the fumble. Initially, it will be Montana's ball, first and 10 at the 12-yard line. First down.
That's just a heads-up play by Nick Osmo right there, saving his buddy's rear end, who just fumbled the ball in his own red zone on third down. Nice job by him, great heads-up play. He just got there before Nolan Askelson by about a split second.
The Grizzlies get the first break of the game.
Yeah, you talk about a big break there. So now first down and 10. In the pistol, McDowell. Eli Gilman looking for a window. And getting inside the five.
Spectacular freshman running back for the Montana Grizzlies. Like we said in the pregame show, this man has speed. He's got a little electricity to him. However, he can also break tackles. Look at this. It's a mess in there. And he bounces it to his left and gets the ball vertical down in the red zone, which is always important.
You see the replay there on the Whitefish Credit Union replay. Yeah, Eli Gilman, we've seen it all season, doing an excellent job breaking tackles. To the ground game again, and into the maroon turf, right on cue. Eli Gilman gets the Grizz on the board first.
Well, what a way to start for the Montana Grizzlies. They have a nice, healthy mix of run and pass. Like Coach was saying, some unbalanced quad sets into the boundary, and a lot of missed tackles for that Bobcat defense. They're going to have to clean that up if they want to compete moving forward.
And Ty, they were 3 for 3 on third down conversions. If Montana State can kind of split that in half and make Montana less than half efficient on third downs, then they'll have a chance to win this ball game.
Nico Ramos on for the PAT. And that one is good. And on the first drive of the afternoon in this 122nd edition of the Brawl of the Wild, it's the redshirt freshman getting into the end zone for the 10th time this season. Grizzly striking first here in Missoula.
Today's game is sponsored by Montana State University, Mountains and Mines, Town Pump, Pump It Up, Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking, your Montana Chevy dealers, and the University of Montana. Our mission is Montana.
Well, again, they've been playing this game for a long time. Some photos from way back in the 1920s. The 122nd edition today right here in Missoula. Obviously, the Grizz have a 73-42-5 advantage in this rivalry. The first matchup, like we mentioned before, where both teams are ranked in the top five. I mean, just a tremendous showdown today in a packed house here at Washington-Grizzly Stadium. Arkie Johnson back to return for Montana State as he will take a knee in the end zone. And now the Bobcats will start from the 25-yard line.
This is going to be fascinating to see the Montana State Bobcats offense against a heck of a rush defense that the Grizzlies have from Montana. You know, that first big break went the Grizzlies' way. There's probably going to be 3 or 4 of those that dictate the outcome of this game.
And again, Ty, like we mentioned, it all starts with that two quarterback system with Tommy Milan and Sean Chambers. The numbers for Milan this season, he's got some speed out in the perimeter, but you see the evolution in his passing game continue. Out of the pistol, hand off to Julius Davis. And he reaches forward for a couple. And once again, some more players to watch, sponsored by Achieve Montana, college savings for their future. And you saw Julius Davis right there. But what does Brent Beacon say all the time, Ty? It all starts with those big boys up front on the O-line.
No question. They call themselves the Don Joy Mafia. They have not just been good this year, Ben. They've been consistently good, even going past, you know, Coach Beacon getting here into the Choate era. They've ran the ball at an incredibly high clip now for years.
Second FCS 302 yards on the ground. Malott trying to turn the corner. He gets leveled just short of the 30 to bring up third down.
Well, it's a great pop there by Nash Fouch and company. You can see when we see the end zone here, this is just A-gap read zone power. You can see the pulling guard, Tommy pulls it. What I think Coach Tommy's so good at, he rides those pulls, as you're going to see throughout the afternoon. And that's hard on a defense. But nice job by this Grizzly defense getting to third and long. That's a huge win against this style of offense for the Bobcats.
Now again, Montana State's offense impressive on third downs this season. 50% the top team in that category in the Big Sky this season on third and six.
This 26,000 plus, they're getting loud in here, Ben.
Barrett White in the backfield, Malott will look to throw. Looking for the deep ball. And that one incomplete. Trying to go to his tight end in Hunter Province.
Gubner for the Montana defense. He's a penetrator. He put a little heat on Tommy Malott right as he threw the ball. You can see him right there. He grabbed the left part of Malott's shoulder pad.
Yeah, Marty, such a big part of that D-line for Montana. I mean, what do you like out of Gubner's game?
Gubner is a penetrator. He likes to wreak havoc in his opponent's backfield, and he's done it time and time again.
Yeah, you see Junior Bergen again. This is going to be a big key for Montana State with the leg of Brendan Hall to limit Bergen in that return game here today. Fair catch. Has to die for it at the 30. So a strong start for Montana on both sides of the ball.
Timeout on the field.
Halfway through this first quarter in Missoula. Les Schwab scoreboard, number 3, Montana with a 7-0 lead over number 4, Montana State, halfway through this first quarter. And fans, time to send in your photos to the hashtag MMAFanZone. You can also email them to fanzone@scripps.com. We've definitely got a lot of good ones throughout the season from not only Bobcat fans, but Grizz fans as well. Make sure to send them in again to the hashtag MMAFanZone. As Clifton McDowell, the offense back on the field. Eli Gilman with the carry, trying to find an opening, and plunges ahead for a gain of 2.
Gilman is such a good back because almost always he's gaining the extra yards. That should have been a run for -1 or 0, and he ends up getting 2 or 3 yards out of the thing.
Again, solid on the ground this season. Empty backfield now for Clifton McDowell. Right now, a balanced attack for Montana. 31 through the air, 46 on the ground here on second down. McDowell, lots of time underneath and finds Aaron Fonts on the far side. Tries to hurdle a defender and pushed out of bounds. And that will be enough for a Grizz first down.
Well, this is part of that early chess match, right? They're giving him lots of different formations. Now we see an empty. They want to see how Coach William Mack Barr's defense adjusts to it. They keep with the 4-man rush. It's just a little TNT twist game here on the outside. And it's a great job by Clifton McDowell just staying in there, finding the open man.
Great job by the Montana offensive line to handle those stunts by the Montana State Bobcat defense.
First down sponsored by Tire-Rama. Already 7 so far in this one. Play action, McDowell. Just has to get rid of it.
But it almost looked like they were trying to set up a screen.
They were. That was going to be a 3-man, 3-count, slow screen to the left. And Montana State sniffed it out, and McDowell had to throw the ball away. You can see this screen being set up to your left, and there's just too many bodies there, and he's got to throw it away. They were lucky that they didn't call Lehman down the field on that play. You can see Montana's throwing the ball a little bit more than expected. Why? Once again, Montana State's run defense is very good in the past.
Sebastian Valdez, by the way, the man in pursuit there. Keelan White, past the 50. And once again into Bobcat territory, and another Montana first down.
A simple RPO. He's reading that first linebacker level bump defender. You can see him here. His eyes are up. He gets a one-on-one outside and throws a quick slant. Well executed. Now, Ty, Montana State doesn't play from behind very often.
No, they don't, Coach. I mean, you can think back to maybe 1-2 times this whole season they've had to play from behind. But high percentage throws for McDowell, who's now 5 of 7 on target, looking sharp.
Harris leaving the backfield. McDowell scurrying, floats it up, wide open. Junior Bergen with a stiff arm and shoved out of bounds.
The Grizzlies have the Bobcats off balance. What a brilliant early game plan by the Montana Grizzlies. Brett Peace, offensive coordinator, Bobby Houck as the winningest head coach in Big Sky history. You can see McDowell, they had no contain on McDowell, so McDowell's gonna take it, Ty, and then he presses the defense to make the defense make choices, and then they left Burgum wide open.
Nick Osmo getting the rock and getting inside the five. By the way, 38-yard completion from McDowell to Junior Bergen. And Marty, I mean, this is a receiving core that has played extremely well as of late for Montana.
Well, it's a talented receiving core. Hey, what's the...
Quickly the line, McDowell scampers into the end zone, and a strong start for the Grizzlies continues.
This is looking like it's going to be 14-0 with a little less than 4.5 left in the first quarter. This is going to be fascinating, Ty, to see how the Bobcats play from two scores behind early in a ballgame.
Well, it's a great game plan by offensive coordinator Brett Pease that's being executed beautifully right now. I mean, they might have gotten a little lucky on that third down where McDowell put the ball on the ground. But you know what? Sometimes you got to coach good, play good, the stars got to align, and you got to get a little lucky in games like these. But it's not luck. The Bobcats are getting whipped right now, and they're going to have to tackle better. And then offensively, they're going to have to respond here. Well, this thing could get ugly in a hurry, Coach.
Already a 2-touchdown lead for the number 3 team in the land. 145 total yards for the Grizzly offense against the second best defense in the Big Sky. Strong start for Montana.
Today's game is sponsored by Town Pump.
Hey guys, welcome back. 14-0 Montana right now. And one of the best parts of the Montana's Brawl of the Wild is, of course, the Montana natives who get the honor to play in this football game in front of the entire state. And so in this game today, we have 92 Montana natives playing in this game between the two teams. Montana has 47 and the Bobcats have 45. And combined, there's 28 communities and cities that are represented in this game today by these guys. So, of course, let's take a look at where they're from. Bozeman and Missoula have the most reps with 15 players from each city. And then Billings, of course, is the largest population city. But how about those small towns? We have Millstone, Savage, and Sunburst, who all have players on the Montana State Bobcats, come from the smallest towns. And, of course, we have 11-man football, 8-man football, 6-man football. It's all repped here and fun to watch these guys out here. Guys?
Appreciate it, Kyle. Yeah, no question. A heated rivalry so special right here in the Treasure State as Montana State's offense back on the field after a 3-and-out. And Ty, obviously, this offense, they're looking to get going here on their second drive.
Well, what a start by the Montana Grizzlies. I mean, they've got Montana State on their heels. Defensively, they haven't stopped them once. Offensively, they got to be able to respond here because this crowd's just getting more and more into it.
Julius Davis breaking a tackle. And Davis to the 40. And you see Julius Davis right there. We talked about it all season. One of the top rushers in the Big Sky. Right now averaging under 7 yards per carry, which leads the conference.
Fleek had him right there. What a great tackle-breaking type of attitude that he has for the Bobcats.
Yeah, Julius Davis is a dude. And what a nice effort and hustle play and tackle by Levi Janicaro there.
15 yards on that run by Julius Davis. New set of downs, Malott. Mazes through, finds an opening. Malott looking to break away to the 30. One tackle to beat and wrapped up inside the 15. And like we mentioned, Ty, when Tommy Malott gets going on that perimeter, he's hard to stop.
Extremely fluid athlete. And what people don't realize is how strong he is. His lower body is so strong. And he gets on the perimeter. Great perimeter blocking out here by his wide receiver core. And the rest is on him.
That guy is a special player. Tommy Malott from Butte, America.
45 yards as Sean Chambers is now in the game for Montana State.
And this is exactly what offensive coordinator Taylor Housewright wants. He wants to get him involved early and often because he is a special weapon in that MSU backfield.
And we got movement before the snap.
There was some confusion, though. You saw it. You saw Sean Chambers.
False start. Number 72 of the offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
They
They were all jacked up there. I mean, you could tell he was trying to chirp to his back, the offensive line, and I think this crowd noise was having an effect on him.
I agree with you, Ty. There was communication problems right from the start, which led to a false start in the red zone. It'll be interesting to see if the Bobcats can overcome a penalty in the red zone.
Well, and I coached here 12 years, boys, and I tell you, the closer they get to that north end zone, man, it gets loud.
Jared White getting the handoff. And maybe a yard there.
Janicaro penetrated to blow that thing up. It looked like the Montana State Bobcats were blocking Janicaro, the man that they may have been reading, and Chambers gave it. It looked like he may should have pulled that one. Malott's back in the game.
They see the numbers in the ABA red zone, fifth in the Big Sky this season for Montana State on second and 15. Malott back in the game for the Bobcats. As he'll go under center, and Brent Vegan talked about this. He said, hey, if we need to go under center, we will with the crowd noise. Ty McCullough in motion for Montana State. Jared White.
That's
no gain there.
That's another inside zone. Some people call it tight zone. And Governor, how do you stop that stuff?
You penetrate, Ty. Exactly. Look at that early penetration here by Alex Governor from West Hills, California. He doesn't make the play, but he impacts the play so that his buddy's in that second level. And I always used to tell linebackers, when you got big, beautiful rear ends in front of you, that's what you want to look at, boys. And my goodness, is he a big, stout dude.
Governor and the crowd is having an influence on this game early in the first quarter.
Five wide on third and 14. Play clock down to two. Malott will pitch it out. And nowhere to go. Julius Davis wrapped up in the backfield as Riley Wilson brings him down.
Riley Wilson has been a big addition to the Montana Grizzlies defense. He is fast, he runs, and he hits.
Yeah, what an addition he's been, because I love this linebacker corps for Montana. Five out of the six in the two deep are from the Treasure State, except for that young man. And when he's in the game, my goodness, does he have an impact, as you saw right there.
42 yards now for Casey Kautzman. Wide left, no good.
Yeah, he pulled it. He's in the sand trap in the back left part of the green if you're playing golf. What a great stop down in the red zone, helped by a false start penalty by the Bobcats. But what a good no point drive for the Montana Grizzlies defense.
Yeah, just when Montana State kind of showing some flashes, some explosive plays there. Tommy Malott's getting involved. They bring Sean Chambers in. They can't even get the play off, put him back behind schedule again. And sure enough, like you just said, Coach, 0 points.
Yeah, so Montana had a turnover that was overturned down in the red zone. The Bobcats have a false start, missed field goal down in the red zone. That's why we're at 14 to nothing.
Montana, their first charge, 30-second timeout.
So even the Grizzlies are having a little communication problem, because that should never happen after the change of possession. You have so much time. So there had to be a miscommunication, either about the play or about the personnel that was on the field there, Ty.
Yeah, and you can see Coach Houck, the winningest coach in the Big Sky ever. He's not real thrilled with what happened. They got Timmy Trumpet in the background. That north end zone is fired up. Right now, I mean, these two teams got to just breathe a little bit. Like you said early in the game, Coach, just relax. I mean, I know the emotions are high. You were talking about foam coming from the mouth like a ravenous Rottweiler. They just need to chill out, settle in, and play ball.
Now focus on your job and the technique that you must use and allow the game to come to you just a little bit.
Play fake. Slings it, Aaron Fox.
A catch.
But incomplete. Unless they'll call him out of bounds. Nope, overruled, it will be a catch.
This may go to the replay because one official called it a catch, one official called it incomplete. I saw a little bobble right as he caught the football. This will be interesting. The Grizz are trying to go fast to prevent the replay.
Yep, 19 yards if this stands, but it looks like they will take a look at this.
This will be interesting to see it on replay.
The play was a completed catch with 1 foot down in bounds. The play is under review.
Yeah, you could tell, you could see McDowell there. He's not real thrilled after the play because he's trying to get the offense up. He knows there might be a little gray area on this. We'll see it right here.
No question, he caught the ball, but was there a little bobble? You can't see it there. Okay, that looks like a catch from that angle. We got to get this angle. You can see it from behind.
You can see 1 foot is in, but 1 foot, they're gonna have to slow that way down.
See how the ball moved, but it looked like he continuously had control of the ball. So that's one issue, and then the other issue is, did he get the foot down?
I tell you, we're gonna keep talking about the Grizzlies, the Bobcats, offense, defense, special teams. A group to keep an eye on is the referees. And I'll tell you why, guys, because this game, the magnitude of this game, this crowd, it is unlike anything they see throughout the year in this conference.
Yeah, so there's right foot down, left foot out. So the issue is just, does he control the ball? I think he controlled the ball.
And the big thing is that Clifton McDowell and this offense, I mean, they're continuing to feed the ball to Aaron Font so far in this one. If this stands, that will already be his third catch of the afternoon.
And the Montana Grizzlies, like we talked about, you would suspect that a team facing a really good run defense would come out throwing the football.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. It's a catch.
Yeah. And it's really positive for the Grizzlies to get Aaron Font back from injury because of those type of plays. He's a real playmaker. He's got speed. He's got hands. He's got big play capability.
Yeah, Junior Bergen saying he's one of the freakiest athletes he's ever been around. Gilman. Past the 45.
Well, that's the first time we've talked about the big man in the middle there. Number 95, Sebastian Valdez. Spring Valley, California.
As that will be the final play of the first quarter. Montana with a 14-0 lead in this top five Brawl of the Wild. As the Grizz offense looks to move down the field again. Second quarter on the other side. A 14-0 lead for Montana. The number 37 flag being raised here at Washington Grizzly Stadium. Of course, senior day. A plethora of big-time playmakers for this Grizz squad being honored before the game. And looking to wrap up the regular season with a huge win here in the Brawl of the Wild as we're underway here in the second quarter. 14-0 lead for number 3, Montana. McDowell looking to throw. He's got a wide-open target on the near side. The junior Bergen near midfield.
Yeah, they had Bergen lined up in the backfield, motion him out to the slot in an empty formation, five receiver type of look, and they ran him on a square out with an outside release wide route, and Montana State had a cloud corner. They were in too deep, so they kept the game to a minimum.
Ty, you and I were talking during the break. For Montana, they needed to get out to a fast start, and that's exactly what they've done so far.
Well, they did. I love the throws they're giving McDowell. I mean, it was a nice tackle there by John Johnson, who I think has progressed a ton this year, but just high percentage on-target throws for Clifton McDowell thus far.
To the screen game, Eli Gilman out in the flat. Breaks away, down the fringe, pushed out of bounds. And moving the chains once again, this Montana offense.
That was a three-man combination route, and McDowell made a good, quick decision, and the ball placement, 1 foot in front of the numbers, gave Eli Gilman a chance to pick the first down up. Let's look at the Montana line. What protection that they're giving McDowell today against this ferocious Bobcat defense.
And that's been a big thing for the Montana offense as well, Marty. I mean, the last couple of games, you look at Clifton McDowell, he's had an eternity in the pocket to throw those passes in the screen game. And again, that all goes back to the offensive line on the reverse, looking to throw. Bergen to the 20 and wrapped up inside the red zone, and the Grizz offense with a little bit of trickery.
Hey, a little special play. McDowell shifted to his right. Osmo shifted to his right. He gave the ball to McDowell. Watch this. Gives the ball to McDowell. All right. And then he pitches it to the lefty. And it's unusual for a lefty to throw the football on the move, and he threw it back to Bergen. What a creative play by Brett Peace. in the Montana Grizzlies offense. They've got Montana State's defense just out of sorts and off balance quite a little bit early in this ball game.
Yeah, it's quite a lot of it right now, Coach. I mean, it's good to see Drew Polidor back in there. He's been dinged up. Both hands have been dinged up.
McDowell with an eternity. And he'll use his legs again, a flag thrown back in the backfield.
I think we're going to have some cheating, a little bit of holding, I would imagine, Coach.
Well, there's two flags out right at the same spot, so two officials probably saw the same thing.
Holding number 66 of the offense. 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Brandon Casey, the guilty party.
Yeah, he's the junior out of Sandpoint, Idaho. Beautiful part of the country up there in the great Northwest. Just got to, you got to get your hands on that breastplate. But then you got to let go.
Yeah, yeah. It was when McDowell was moving around. When a defender releases your suspension, you've got to release the defender so you don't get the holding call.
It's a unique formation right here, Coach.
Free play.
And another flag.
They blew it. I thought it was going to be a free play, but it looks like, oh, they're calling it on the Grizzlies. Huh.
Well, you can see that's why Brody Grebe.
False start. 66 offense, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Again, Brandon Casey.
Well, I'm telling you guys, and just evaluating and getting to watch this Montana State outfit all season long, Brody Grebe, he kind of puts you on your heels a little bit. His get off is fantastic.
Yeah, it initially looked in real time like Montana State was in the neutral zone. But obviously, the referees have done a nice job today. The Grizz must have moved just a little bit pre-snap.
And more movement.
Well, this is almost kind of getting ugly here in the last few plays, boys.
Yeah, that looked like Valdez was a little quick.
Offside, number 95 of the defense in the neutral zone with punt. 5-yard penalty, it's still first down.
We go back 10 yards, now we go forward 5 yards.
and it started down in the red zone, about the 15 or 16 yard line. So both teams have had major penalties. The ball was on the ground once in the red zone. When you get in the red zone, man, you gotta focus in. The lanes are tighter, things happen faster.
Gilman all alone in the backfield once again on first down. And a loss of one there.
You bet. That's just a sandwich there. He just got a penalty and redeemed himself. Number 95, Sebastian Valdez. And the big fella from Billings, Montana, West High School, Paul Broad. You and I have watched him recently. He makes some plays. He's taking advantage of those turns, Ben.
Yeah, he's really come alive over the last couple of games for Brent Vegan's defense.
He goes about 285. He's a big man on the left side of the Montana offensive line.
Five wide set once again for Montana on second and 21. Pressure coming, McDowell. Once again brought down behind the line, and Ty, really for the first time today, that Montana State stout D-line making some plays.
That was zero blitz. They brought everybody and their mamas on that one, and they were single coverage everywhere. You can see that there was at least one Bobcat that was unblocked, so McDowell just took off and tried to find a crease, because if he finds a crease, he's probably in end zone. Great job by the Montana State defensive staff with calling that blitz on second and 21.
Yeah, defensive-wise, if you get an empty set, you got three things. You can play the call, play zone, or bring the house. And like you said, Coach, they brought the house and took advantage of the situation.
The Bobcats not only brought everybody and their mama, but everybody, their mama and grandmama on that one. I mean, it was all out blitz on second and 21, which is unusual.
Timeout called by Montana State. Third and long for the Grizzlies when we come back.
Today's game is sponsored by Montana State University, Mountains and Mines, Town Pump, Pump It Up, Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking, your Montana Chevy dealers, and the University of Montana. Our mission is Montana.
Great old-time photos here at the Brawl of the Wild, dating back 100 years, and you look at the numbers right now for both teams. For Montana, already over 200 total yards. McDowell on third and long. Just has to dump it off to Eli Gilman. Stays on his feet and plunges ahead for a couple of yards to bring up fourth down.
That was an excellent job by Seymour. Just keeping contained on the game that they were running against McDowell and the Grizzly offensive line. And nice job of rallying to the football by the Bobcat defense.
Yeah, it was. You can see that front four for Montana State slash front eight. Best depth probably on the team, except maybe a healthy running back room. That front four has imposed its will for 3 months now.
40-yarder for Nico Ramos. And a flag thrown right through the uprights. But we'll see what the flag is.
Bobby's going to decline the penalty and take the field goal, only because 5 yards would do them no good. They certainly wouldn't go for it. You know, on fourth down, they'd have to recut. So that was a classic decline the penalty.
Offside, number one of the defense. A penalty is declined. The kick is good.
Yeah, decline the penalty and take the points. It's that simple.
So a 20-0 lead. 17 lead for the Grizz.
And welcome back, everybody, to Washington Grizzly Stadium here in Missoula, where the Grizz lead it 17-0 over the Bobcats. One of the big prizes in this thing is the Great Divide Trophy, of course, and they came up with that idea back in 2001. They came up with the name because, of course, naturally, the two campuses are divided by the Continental Divide. Thing is, you can't just walk over and pick it up. It weighs over 300 pounds. It's like grabbing one of your biggest linemen, trying to lug him around the field afterward in celebration. They're playing for it. We'll see who takes it home for the next 364 days, about an hour and a half from now. Guys?
Appreciate it, Scott. Another touchback. Yeah, 306 pounds, that big old trophy. And obviously, Montana looking to bring it back here to Missoula.
Well, obviously, all the momentum is for the maroon and silver right now. But what Montana State's got to do, even on that last play that was declined by head coach Bobby Houck, there was still an offside defender. They've got to settle down, settle in, and start playing that Bobcat. You know, they're the number four team in the country. Now they got to start acting like it.
Yeah, with them being the second best rushing team in all of FCS, right now only 59 total yards, and a lot of that came on that huge Tommy Mellott run. That's right on cue. He'll take it as he gets up the middle past the 30.
This is a huge, huge, epic type of drive, both for the Montana State offense. They've got to get some points on the board or it could get ugly, but also for the Grizz defense. Can they stop him once again and get this thing to a three or four score type of game?
No, 12 personnel, you're gonna go to unbalanced formation here. You can see Pickering and Longer in shift to an unbalanced. Bobcat Nation's gotta be happy to see the young man from Sunburst, Montana, back playing football.
Hand off Julius Davis. And he'll move the sticks for Montana State.
This Davis is a heck of a powerful runner. He also has quickness and speed. And that was two plays, one by Mellott, one by Davis, right up the gut of the Montana Grizz defense for a first down.
Yeah, you talk about a big addition for this Bobcat squad out of Wisconsin. Julius Davis has been fantastic. Fourth in the Big Sky in rushing yards per game this season. As he enters the backfield to the left of Tommy Mellott on first down. As he gets the rock again. Davis turning the corner. And it's a foot race with a stiff arm, and Julius Davis with a couple big runs here on this drive.
Yeah, again, they're staying 12 personnel. One back, two tight ends. Trying to get these tight ends involved again. And again, I've said it, since Derek Snell's been out of the lineup, what a huge loss. Just a split zone type play. Great job by Pickering there on the edge, securing it just enough to get Julius Davis. Big explosive play, exactly what this Bobcat offense needs right now.
Yeah, Jace Klusiewicz with a touchdown saving tackle right there.
31 yards for Julius Davis. Can Montana State capitalize? Halfway through the second quarter, down 17-0 in the pistol. Now going to Scottrey Humphrey, the freshman, finding a window and a little burst up the middle. Ty, just short of the 20.
Ty, I'm a little surprised that Montana State hasn't tried throwing the ball with all these one-on-ones. That defensive structure, there wasn't one defender. There was more than 6 yards.
No question. But what they're doing, coach, is they're getting back to their bread and butter. On first down, if you're going to get 9 yards a pop, stick with it. This freshman is outstanding. They've got a stable of running backs that is second in the FCS in rushing the football.
Overall, first in the FCS in yards per carry. Sniffing him out behind the line, Alex Gubner.
Gubner again. Again and again. Gubner's done it all year long. That was a second and one is a great time to go play action, touchdown, check down. And then if you don't get it, you're in a third one. Well, now, because of Gubner's penetration, they're back of the third and four.
Totally agree, coach, in terms of the opportunity there to maybe take a little shot. But big Gubner, man, 3 sacks on the year, his 8th tackle for loss. Love the way that big sucker plays inside.
Third down and four, Milan under center.
Nope.
Once again behind the line. This time Levi Janicaro with the tackle for loss to bring up fourth down.
Janicaro is a heck of a player for the Montana Grizzlies defense. He shot the A-gap. You can see it right here. Boom! To make the tackle in the backfield, the Montana State Bobcats are going for it on a fourth and long 5 here.
Well, they showed him a bare front, coach, a nose with 2 threes, and just played a little zip game inside. And yeah, 2 very penetrative plays there by the linebacking core and defensive line of this Grizz defense.
Montana State 7 of 9 on fourth downs this season. On 4th and 5, Milan will look to throw. Deep shot. Incomplete. No flag and a turnover on downs.
Big time play by that Montana defense to bow up. They get to 2nd and 1. And then they start getting a tackle for loss and get another one to move them back. That's exactly where you want to put this Montana State offense, because that is not their bread and butter.
It was a really good matchup. That's why Milat threw the ball a tight end on a safety. And Ryder Meyer, great job in coverage.
Time to take a look at your photos on the hashtag MMA Fan Zone. Well, you know she's excited for this start so far for the Grizzlies. Friends and family watching the game and from all over. How about in Cancun watching the Brawl of the Wild? Definitely a warm place to watch it. All the way from Georgia. You got fans of both teams from all across the United States. And obviously right here in the great state of Montana and Helena. And obviously some excited fans right now down the Lone Star State. And after a strong defensive stop, Junior Bergen gets short of the 35.
I'm not going to lie, Cancun sounds pretty nice right now.
But, you don't like the cold weather for a big game like this?
I need to get kind of weaned into it a little bit. You know, we've already had single-digit snow over in Bozeman. But, you know, hey, nice first play to get him in second and short. Nice backside pursuit there by Brody Grebe.
I'll tell you, this is a beautiful sight in Washington Grizz Stadium. It is a full house, and it is loud.
Gain of 7. On the read, McDowell busting through the hole, past midfield, and pushed out of bounds. Again, he can do it in both ways with his arm and with his feet.
Classic read option. It's something that McDowell has become an expert at. He's reading end men on line of scrims. End men on line of scrims can tackle the man he's handing the ball off to, so then he pulls it and it becomes quarterback power.
And more often than not, guys, that offensive lineman, they're going to tell you where the ball is going. You got 600 pounds pulling back to the boundary. Believe it. Trust your eyes. Get over there. Nice job by Montana's offense.
Now to Nick Osmo.
Osmo's always getting that 2 or 3 extra yards. just by leaning forward. He strolls so strong in that lower body. Osmo is a bigger positive for Montana's offense than even his numbers show, because he plays in such a physical manner.
And back to QB1, how about this? Leading the way rushing so far, Clifton McDowell, 37 yards on the ground. Now with his arm scrambling. Off balance throw, and under throws his target in Aaron Fonts.
Well, it's a nice job here by Blake Schmidt. You'll see it here from the end zone. You know, Clifton starts to move a little bit. Second, third level, when he starts to scramble, you got to plaster, look for work. But it's a nice job here by Blake Schmidt, number 92, out of San Diego, California, coming back over the top of that guard and making Clifton McDowell throw the football away.
And again, you see the numbers for the Grizz QB. 10 of 13 through the air right now, already with 129 yards through the air. All alone in the backfield on 3rd and 8. High snap, regains, and again underthrows his target.
That's a great job by the Bobcat defense right there. They sort of strangled the Montana offense just a little bit. I would expect Bobby Houck to put his punt team out there and try to get Montana State backed up inside the 10-yard line here.
My eyes might have been fooling me, but I could have swore that 66, Brandon Casey, moved a little early on that one as well.
He was a little early. His flag didn't come out. All great pass rushers, all great pass protectors, jumped the gun just a little bit.
Taco Dowler back to return for the Bobcats. And he will call fair catch at around the 6. Montana State's offense still looking to get rid of that goose egg as we wind down this first half of Missoula. Well, we knew this Montana defense was impressive this season. Tops in the Big Sky, one of the tops in the FCS. And right now, I mean, they're doing their job against this Montana State offense.
They are living up to all expectations. They've given up 17 points in the last 3 games, and it looks like a possible shutout in the first half of the Brawl of the Wild for the Grizz defense. It's a false start by the Bobcats.
That's the north end zone, man. The north end zone crazies are bowing up, and they're saying, you're going to hear us, feel us.
False start. Number 63 offense, half the distance to the goal. It's still first down.
Rush Reimer called for the false start.
When I was the defensive coordinator here, guys, we always used to kind of say, okay, we'd put a number down in a defensive meeting on Friday. What's the number? How many false starts can we get the offense to get? Right now, I'd say they're on track.
A lot.
Oh, what a hit.
Trying to plunge ahead for a couple yards.
What a hit by Braxton Hill. He scraped to the left side of the defense. The Grizz D-line were pitching, and he hit Tommy Malott. And Tommy Malott's whole family felt that hit.
First on the team in tackles, Anaconda Montana guy. You got to love him. Second in the Big Sky with 8.3 tackles per game. And yeah, you know, we talked to Taylor Housewright, the offensive coordinator for the Cats, on Thursday, and he was saying, this is a unique system. Our lanes, our path, our track, they have to be perfect. Right now, they are not. And this Montana defense is playing extremely well.
Now the handoff up the middle. Julius Davis past the 10.
Yeah, they got out of it. They got, okay, so here's what Montana State has done. They got the punter room with the quarterback sneak. They've got a chance to get that first down of a 94, 96 yard touchdown drive, right? And then possibly take a shot. The Grizzlies did that a week ago for a 97 yard touchdown pass. So this will be an interesting play for the Montana State Bobcat offense.
Yeah,
how aggressive are they going to be?
Yeah, Montana State, by the way, struggling today. 0 for 3 on third downs. And this is a team that leads the Big Sky in third down completions. Ground game again. Julius Davis short of the first down marker to bring up fourth down.
I am a little surprised, Ty, about how unaggressive, or maybe they're just trying to play to their great strength running game. You've got to be able to throw the ball, I think, in this particular game to beat the Grizzly defense.
I was just going to say the same thing, Coach. I mean, I've seen third and three. Third and three as a defense, a lot of times you're getting them to throw the football. Well, this with this Cat offense, they will run the ball. It's just this rush defense for the Grizz is so stout. I thought it was, it could have been a little more aggressive call myself.
Well, Coach Vegan, who has a huge winning percent, I mean, he's one of the greatest, he better get in at halftime and with his offensive staff and make an adjustment or two. They kicked it to Bergen.
Bergen getting a couple on that return. With under 90 ticks left in this first half.
Great play by the Missoula product there. Rylan Ort, you know how much I love that young man. But yeah, Brendan Hall's a difference maker because he can really flip the field. They needed a great punt out of their own end zone. That being said, guys, with a minute 27 seconds, it's still on the 48 with Montana clicking on all cylinders.
Yeah, Rylan Ort saved a big play. Look at the attendance here.
Yeah, no question, a new Big Sky record. I mean, you knew this was going to be a humongous crowd today for what's being dubbed the biggest brawl in the history of this rivalry.
Minute 23 left, and they bring the freshman Ayotte in at quarterback. They're going to pass the ball. They're going to try to make this game a four-score difference.
A lot of infractions in the first half, Coach. I mean, you know, whether it's the crowd or the boys' nerves.
Yeah, or the new quarterback.
Illegal snap, number 57 of the offense. Yeah. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Yeah, so there's a different cadence to it sometimes when you bring the backup, the young freshman. Now this
Hold on. Xavier Watson.
I was going to say, still had the mic on.
No, he's explaining the whole process to 26-plus.
Yeah. Now, this Ayotte, this quarterback, he's out of Hawaii. This man can really spin the football. He's accurate. He makes good decisions. He also has some instincts.
Of course, part of a legacy here in Missoula with loads of time. Incomplete. Of course, the son of Brian Ayotte. One of the top quarterbacks of all time in this Grizz program.
Well, he got a little late pressure there by number 11, Kenny Iden. Bozeman, Montana product, and I got to say it, nice job by Coach Levi Weshey and that Bozeman Hawk football team getting their seventh state championship last night.
Congratulations to them.
Yeah, you bet. I mean, that's huge. I mean, those championships of any kind aren't easy to get. Nice job by them. Nice job by that young man getting them to third and long.
Ayotte escaping pressure, still looking for something to get going, but tripped up. Rylan Ort, the hometown product from right here in Missoula.
So I was bragging on Ayotte's decision making and the play before that one. He threw it almost right to a defender, and then this one, you can see his athleticism, backdoor, but right here, eyes deep, middle, short, and then always have the throwaway in mind when you're on the move. That would have saved them some field position where they could have got the Bobcats backed up once again.
A 9-yard loss. As Dowler will let it bounce and it will take a favorable Montana State roll to the 35-yard line.
Little extracurricular activities right there on the punt by both teams. Look, 39 seconds left. The Bobcats have two timeouts. They should be aggressive here, Ty. Even though they're a running team, they have to put some points on the board to get back into this game. Look, if it's 17-3 or 17-7 at half, this is a ball game. If it's 17-0, it's a little bit different in the locker room at halftime.
Coach, just to have a little bit of confidence going into that, even if you just get 3 points, it's something. You're not shut out in the first half like they were at Idaho that they could never recover from and lost the ball game.
Ballot can't find an open receiver, still looking, and he'll scamper with his legs again. Short of the first down marker. Yeah, Tommy Malott in this Montana State offense, only 2 passes so far in this first half.
Yeah, I'm surprised too. I mean, just with what Coach was saying earlier, you know, Tommy's been really, really on point, on target since coming back from that injury. You know Montana's defense is unique. You know they can stop the run. Maybe give him some chances to throw the ball and see what he can do.
He'll try it here. Incomplete. That one almost picked off.
I'll tell you, it doesn't look good up to date for Tommy Malott and the Bobcat offense. However, Tommy Malott's a special dude. If you've got him on your your ball club playing quarterback, you're never out of a game. So let's see what happens on this big third and short.
No question, 17-3 as a starter. He's an old soul, he's a leader.
Hand off to Jared White.
They're going to mark him short,
yep,
guys.
That'll be short. Fourth down.
Well, does Montana State take a timeout, or do they let the clock keep running? It looks like they're just going to let the clock run and get to halftime. Now, here's what I'd do. I'd call a timeout with about 3 seconds left and then throw a Hail Mary into the end zone.
Yep, they'll take a timeout with five ticks left.
Yeah, so is what you do is the play's going to, I would have gone three, but the play's going to be more than 5 seconds, right? And you get one chance at a Hail Mary to score down there.
Ruling on the play is the runner was short of the line to gain. Play is being reviewed.
So they'll actually take a look at this.
Yeah, they're going to take a look at the spot. I mean, from our angle, and again, we're a long way away, and we're way up. I actually thought it was a good spot. He looked short to me.
Yeah, and it might not be just quite that short. Yeah, so ball's right there. It looks a touch short. They've got him a full yard. But getting back to the strategy, I would take a timeout with about 3 seconds left, get a shot for a touchdown on Hail Mary, and there's no ramifications if it falls incomplete where the Grizzlies can line up and take their own shot.
Yeah, it's confirmed. He's just a little bit short.
So it will be a fourth down.
So they got Chambers in there to throw a possible Hail Mary type of thing. It might be a catch and lateral. I typically don't do that at the end of half because you've got negative ramifications of scoop and score. But they don't be surprised if anything happens here because they're down 17-0. Another thing, Ty, that you've seen in these situations is throw a receiver quick screen and make it like a punt return with a bunch of dudes in front of you blocking and try to score that way.
No, it's an excellent call, Coach. I'm actually a little surprised just looking at the secondary for UM. I'd almost scoot him back
after
another.
Reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Short of the line to gain. Timeout, Montana State. Their second charge timeout.
Well, it looks like we're going to get to sit here and visit about it further, fellas.
Yeah, so Coach Vegan, excellent strategy here. There's very little negative that can happen. I suppose a pick down there, and here you go on a fast break going the other way, or a sack fumble, something like that. But it's very, very small, the negative backfire in your face. And the positive is that you get a chance for a PI down the field. You get a chance for a catch and a touchdown. And let's see how strong Chambers' arm is here.
Pressure coming. Chambers being chased and brought down. Another tackle for loss. This time, Cale Edwards brings him down to end the first half.
Young man from Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, man. Coeur d'Alene High School, the Vikings, a great program there in North Idaho. This front from Montana is just getting after the Bobcats. Houston, we have a problem. They got some serious evaluating and re-evaluating to do at the half.
Shutout for the Grizz defense in the first half. That was Chambers. They were trying to dash. They were trying to move him to the right side of the field and then throw the football deep. They're calling some players back out here. Why? Because maybe there was a tick left on the clock. That's why you call the timeout at like 3 seconds rather than five, because
It's so funny.
The sack happened so quickly.
Yes, I mean you kind of gave us a preview in terms of just the clock in what maybe should be done in terms of management.
Yeah.
And sure enough, I mean they're gonna review this and there might still be a click.
Yeah. It looks like that's what they're doing in the Brawl of the Wild. They're calling the players back on the field when both sides have left to go into the locker room for halftime.
Well, we'll see it right here.
When the player was down, there was still 1 second left in the second quarter. First down, Montana, 31-yard line.
So do they put their field goal kicker out there, and that would be about a 48, 49 yarder. I suspect that's what they'll do. Or do they put their offense out and throw a Hail Mary?
Well, they had the fans fooled too, Coach, because there's a lot of fans dressed up as empty seats right now. They were already getting out to have something cold at halftime, or really hot, whatever warms your soul in this chilly weather.
Here comes the field goal team. So it looks like about a 49-yarder. Bobby Houck is getting everything straight with his field goal team out there. And now look, 49-yarder, it's in the 40s here. He's going to have to steroid jerk this just a little bit to get it between the posts.
Yeah, Grant Glasgow on to try to increase this first half lead.
Didn't quite get there,
there's
Ty.
There's a flag, and Glasgow's down on the turf.
All the guys in white.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker. Number four of the defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down. There will be one more play.
Looks like they're going to have to use another kicker.
I've already said it, though. I mean, Coach Vegan is a very even-keeled guy. I would absolutely go off on this team for all the stupid penalties that have occurred right there. You never, ever run into a kicker, especially when every point counts in the biggest game of the season.
Yeah, big, big mistake there by John Johnson.
Huge mistake. It looks like all of the momentum, all the breaks have gone Montana's way. They got Ramos in there now, Ty and Ben.
And you're just a lot nicer than me, Coach, because that's not a break. That's just bad ball.
So now it's a 33-yarder for Nico Ramos. Right through the uprights. Well, quite a crazy way to end this first half here in Missoula. A 20-zip lead for the number three team in the land over number four. And the big thing too, guys, we talked about this, the strength of that defensive line and overall this defense for Montana. How about this through the first 30 minutes? A sack and four tackles for loss right now for the Grizz defense.
That's the way the Grizzlies defense plays, right? They want to wreak havoc in their opponent's backfield.
Let's go down to Kyle Hansen's with Bobby Houck.
Hey guys, I'm here with Montana head coach Bobby Houck. Kind of a wild ending there for your guys there, Bobby, but you're up 20-0. Just what can you say about your performance so far?
Yeah, that was interesting. A lot to unpack in 5 seconds. So, you know, they use their timeout to run more and more play. I don't think they could throw at the end zone, so I'm not sure, but good for us.
14-play drive to start the game with that first touchdown. How much did that set the tone for your offense the rest of that first half?
Yeah, one more time, Kyle.
14-play drive in that first half, or in that first drive of the game. Just how much did that set the tone for you guys in this game?
Well, you know, it's good to be up, and you like getting points on that first drive. You work it pretty hard at the end of the week, so I was good by our guys.
Defensive performance, obviously you guys got two stops deep in your own territory. Just what can you say about those guys?
Well, they're playing hard. They're playing well. There's some things we got to shore up a little bit, but, you know, the other side's pretty good, too.
Awesome. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it. Back to you guys.
All right, Kyle, appreciate it. Again, a 20-zip lead for number three Montana over number four Montana State. Coming up, it's the Montana Chevy Dealers Halftime Report right after this here from Washington Grizzly Stadium.
Time now for the Scripps Sports Montana Chevy Dealers Halftime Report.
No. Do I need one?
Well, welcome into the Montana Chevy Dealers Halftime Report. The 122nd Brawl of the Wild, and it has been a dandy. Rather one-sided right now, but we'll see. Another half to go. Jay Cohn joined by Alex Eshelman of the Big Sky Conference. And Alex, in addition to this 122nd Brawl, we're celebrating 60 years of the Big Sky Conference this year.
That's right, Jay. In 20 of those years, Kaipalani Wallwork Fake has been hosting the Brawl of the Wild watch party all the way from Hawaii. We're saying hello to you guys from Missoula. We miss you here. She's, of course, the daughter of former Grizz all-time great Bruce Wallwork. I caught up with her as well as Bruce and Bruce's wife, Susan, earlier this week talking about those 60 years. And she got a little emotional saying that this annual event means much more to her than just a game.
I love where I live. I love the life that I have, but Montana, it's in my heart. And my parents, you know, having them here is great, but, you know, I'm proud that I grew up in Montana. I'm thankful to my dad for being the stellar athlete that he was, and to starting out the, you know, what is an amazing pipeline from Hawaii to Montana. And I'm proud of my mom for having worked at the University of Montana for over 50 years. And I'm just the product of two amazing, you know, Grizzlies.
Just one of over 90 watch parties, Jay, happening across the U.S. today. Thank you all for tuning in and celebrating 60 years of Big Sky.
Yes, this Brawl of the Wild is truly a nationwide event. We really excited with all those watch parties. Hope everyone's having a great time. When we come back, we'll take a look at the other FCS scores of the day, including one big upset so far. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Scripps Sports Montana Chevy Dealers Halftime Report.
Welcome back to our halftime report. Of course, there's other FCS games going on that all have impacts on the FCS playoff picture. Let's take a look. Of course, here it's Grizzlies 20-0 at halftime. Not sure anyone predicted that, but another half to go. Let's take a look at the other FCS scores from around the country today, and a lot of them, including one big upset right at the top. Wofford over number 2 Furman, 19-13. That would very likely mean that the winner of this game between the Bobcats and the Grizzlies, number 2 seed in the upcoming playoffs. South Dakota State, number 1. They're leading Missouri State right now, 7-3. And Villanova leads Delaware, 28-7. We've got a few more scores. South Dakota, they're leading 17-6 over Western Illinois. They're ranked 5th. And down in the California, it's UC Davis leading Sac State in the Causeway Classic, 7-0 underway in the first quarter. The Vandals and Idaho State go tonight. One other Montana tour to talk about, Montana Tech against Dickinson State in the NAIA playoffs, is Montana Tech 14-7 late in the second quarter. Ben, Ty, and Marty on the other side of the break for highlights of this first half. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Scripps Sports Montana Chevy Dealers Halftime Report.
Welcome back to halftime. A 20-zip lead for number 3 Montana over number 4 Montana State. And Ty, quickly, your thoughts on that first half.
Well, just from the MSU side, it's hard to stay positive. A lot of missed tackles on defense, and offensively, it's just kind of discombobulated. You know, they get a couple big plays, but they can't extend any drives. They're 0-for-5 on third down, Ben.
And, of course, talking to a former Grizz QB, Marty, I got to ask you about Clifton McDowell. He's had a strong game so far.
Clifton McDowell rushing the football, 7 rushes for 41 yards and a touchdown. Passing the football, 10 for 14, 129 yards. He's living up to his expectations in the Brawl of the Wild.
Yeah, again, this Grizz offense has been absolutely clicking over the last 6 games. Really now the last 6.5 games, with McDowell taking full reins of the offense as they have a 20-zip lead here in the 122nd edition of the Brawl of the Wild. You mentioned the stats so far, Marty. I mean, he's been solid with his arm, he's been solid with his legs, and you look at the overall stats right now, obviously in favor of the Grizz.
Well, it's, you know, this game is about one grown man kicking another grown man's butt, and the Montana Grizzlies, at least in the first half, have done that. You know, getting back to McDowell, his mobility has shown up in this 2023 Brawl of the Wild.
Second half next. Les Schwab scoreboard, 20-0, number 3 Montana over number 4 Montana State, as the Grizz faithful right here at Washington-Grizzly Stadium looking for another strong 30 minutes. Bobby Houck right there, certainly impressed with those first 2 quarters from his Grizz offense and defense. Marquis Johnson back to return for Montana State as they'll get the ball to start this second half. 30 minutes to decide a Big Sky title, and another touchback as we go down to Scott Breen.
Yeah, thanks, guys. I had a chance to talk to Coach Brent Vegan coming out of the Bobcats locker room there at halftime and said, what do you do, you know? He said, keep it simple. He said, I told him to forget it. Just forget the first half ever happened. He said, we just have to finish some tackles, make some plays, finish some drives. This opening drive of the third quarter is critical, though. Starting to warm up down here a little bit, fellas. Back up to you.
Yeah, no question. Ty, you and I were talking about it during the break. This is a humongous first drive for Montana State. They have to put some points up on the board here.
Well, I mean, just to build a little confidence, get a drive going, get a third down conversion, et cetera, et cetera.
Milan on the read. And gets maybe a gain of run there. Here's the thing. Offensively for Montana State, as you look at the drives here, couple punts, turnover on downs. I mean, outside of a big run from Tommy Milan as well as one from Julius Davis, I mean, not much offensively so far for the Bobcats.
Well, they've thrown the ball three times. They haven't completed a pass. You can't beat anybody doing that, let alone one of the top defenses in the country, talking about the Grizzlies.
And a nice opening hit there by Zero, Cale Edwards, kind of a little bit setting the tone for this Grizzly defense.
Again on the read, Milan.
Gone.
Turns on the Jets, Milan past midfield and gets into Grizz territory.
Hey, we're celebration time. They got a big play by the great Tommy Milan. Now look at it, it's 20 to nothing. Montana State is not out of this, the old tale of two halves. Like my wife Lindsay says, if it's gonna be the tale of two halves, I'd rather have the second half. So is it gonna be that way for Montana State Bobcats, or does the Grizzlies rise up and stop them here?
Wisdom from the Morningweg family. 30 yards there for Tommy Milan, first down.
Well, and what a wonderful lady Lindsay Morningweg is. I gotta tell you and I both outkicked our coverage on that one, Coacher.
I'll pull some pictures out on you.
Milan with the deep shot. Going to Jacob Trimble, incomplete. And a lot of contact, no flag, second down.
No, I thought it was good coverage, good no call.
Trajan Cotton, the man in coverage.
Excellent coverage by Cotton. Look, the Montana State offensive team, they're gonna have one-on-ones down the field just like this with no help. They've got to hook up on some of those if they wanna get back into this ball game.
Well, and to Coach's point, zero passing yards right now by that Montana State offense.
Yeah, 0 for 4 in this game. McCall, the man in motion. Julius Davis up the seam. Julius Davis staying on his feet and in the red zone.
Well, look at that balance by a big guy. I mean, earlier in the year, I said he's brought a Big Ten running style to the Big Sky. I mean, I think the world of Ryder Meyer, what an outstanding young man. But this is, boom, get off me and just keep going, good hips.
That's a heck of a run by that young man.
A big run there on the opportunity bank, instant replay. First and 10. From the 19, Milan on the slant, finds Ty McCullough, breaks away, touchdown, Montana State as the Bobcats finally on the board.
Just what Coach said, get Tommy going in the throwing game a little bit, or just see what can happen, and get it into a playmaker's hands like Ty McCullough, who brings the juice on the perimeter.
And it doesn't have to be a bunch of passes, but you better keep the Montana Grizzly defense off balance. The first completion goes for a touchdown. The Bobcats are back in this ball game.
Yeah, talk about a big way to have your first completion of the day, and it goes to Ty McCullough for 6. And the extra point is good. It's the Brawl of the Wild. Fun start to this second half here in Missoula. Number 4, Montana State on the board.
Today's game is sponsored by Montana State University, Mountains and Mines, Town Pump, Pump It Up, Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking, your Montana Chevy dealers, and the University of Montana. Our mission is Montana.
A lot of classics here in the Brawl of the Wild, and here in the 122nd edition, now a two-score game, only took 2 minutes to get into the end zone. The first score of the afternoon for Montana State. Brendan Hall will boot it away. And in front of the goal line, here's Junior Bergen. Dangerous in that return game. Bergen able to get past Brendan Hall. Close to midfield, still on his feet. And like I said, so dangerous in that kick return game.
Don't kick it to Junior Bergen. It's just that simple. Now, boy, Montana State's relying on the kickoff game for it to go in the end zone, out of the end zone.
No question. But this is a great job by the special teams unit, and then the rest is just on Bergen. I mean, Brendan Hall at 6'9", does a good job, but great hustle here by Lane Sumner out of Huntley, Montana, to get that young man down, because it's a play like that, a Mark Mariani that opens up a game for you, where next thing you know, you're just saying bye-bye because of a big special teams play.
Right at midfield is where they'll start their first drive of the second half.
Big challenge for the Montana State Bobcat defense, because they got momentum. They're back in this game. Their offense just sliced and diced the Montana Grizzly defense, right? Can they step up and get a three and out here with really good field position for the Grizzlies? Can they do that and keep the momentum?
232 total yards for Montana. Back to Junior Bergen. And knocked out of bounds a couple yards short of the first down marker to bring up third down.
Great block by Eli Gilman for his buddy Junior Bergen on that play. It was a right shoulder block. Watch it right here. Gilman's the lead, but boom! Right there. Nice play by Montana State number 43.
Yep, that's McCade O'Reilly, another Bozeman product. Brother Callahan was a great player for the Cat defense, but you're right. Great perimeter block, just springing an extra few yards.
Out of the pistol, Eli Gilman. Picks up a first down and more.
Big first down for the Grizzly offense. They're close to scoring range. Eli Gilman looked like a slasher right there on that play. This guy is motivated to gain the extra yards against the Bobcat defense.
Let me just watch him here on the replay, bouncing to the outside. But a big thing that I like about Gilman is that he's a real downhill runner.
No doubt. This is kind of that where they pass the midway point on the field, you know, some trickery, little, you know, just like in the first quarter.
Play action, McDowell with a strike, able to thread the needle. And that one hauled in for a catch and another first down.
Beautiful throw and catch. I mean, McDowell has really been on point. Got him early involved in this throwing game. You could see Missoula product, Ryland Ort, trying to hunt like a missile there and just got it in there. Nice throw by Clifton McDowell.
Nice throw, nice route by Deck. Drew Deck comes in the game and catches an important pass to get him down close to the red zone.
Now 14-yard strike there. Another new set of downs. McDowell looking to keep it. And at the 20.
Yeah, again, it's that quarterback counter. They're bringing 600 pounds back to the boundary. Nice job by Ryland Ort and company getting them to a second and long situation down here as they're in the red zone.
By the way, the Grizz today, a perfect 3-for-3 in the red zone. Just shy of that on second and 8. Over the middle, floats it. Caught, touchdown Montana. They punch right back. Junior Bergen once again.
Well, Junior Bergen, this is just a one-on-one situation here. He flat beats number 8, Lavelle Price, the senior nickel out of Los Angeles, California. And what a response by Montana's offense.
Big time response. The Bobcats go down and score in 2 minutes. Watch Bergen here. It's a little nod to the outside. Bam! And then he crosses face for a touchdown coming from McDowell's arm. What a drive by the Montana Grizzlies.
Answering right back, this Montana offense.
Junior Bergen with the kickoff return to set that drive up. Then he ends it with a brilliant touchdown reception.
Marty, you nailed it right before the break. Junior Bergen getting that drive going for Montana with another big return. And then he follows it up with a 20-yard TD reception.
Big Ben, if you're playing against the Grizzlies, do not punt or kick the ball to Bergen, and please cover him when he's out wide on offense.
Well, you saw a situation there too where, you know, Willie Mack Garza dialed up a pressure, but in doing so, you're putting that secondary in one-on-one matchups. Bergen just won that one.
Time once again to send in your photos to the hashtag MMA Fan Zone. Again, keep sending in your photos, whether you're a Grizz fan or a Bobcat fan. We'll share more of them coming up later on here in the second half. And yeah, Junior Bergen leading the way in the receiving corps, 86 yards with that touchdown. And a deep threat at a 38-yard reception early in this game. So now Tommy Malott and the Montana State offense looking to answer right back with another successful drive here in the third quarter.
Junior Bergen, such a talented young man out of Billings, Montana, the magic city, the gateway to the West. What a fantastic player he's become.
Julius Davis spins for a couple yards.
Yeah, that's that inside linebacker, number 44, Ryan Terrell, the Missoula Loyola product, also the nephew of head coach Bobby Houck.
That's right. He's really built himself up into a heck of a player that has helped the Grizzlies defense be one of the very best in the whole nation this year.
Remember recruiting him out of high school. I actually went and watched him play. He's a fantastic young man, great family.
Lonergan in motion, back to the ground game. And Julius Davis reaches forward.
You know, the Bobcats had a heck of a drive in and with a touchdown pass last drive, but I still think the Montana Grizz are clearing their secondary. It's a lot of bump and run. Some people call it press. I think to win the game, the Bobcats are going to have to take some shots against that one-on-one coverage.
Well, they also got to convert on third downs. 0 for 5 today, this Bobcat offense.
Haven't converted. I mean, it's an empty set here, 5 wide, so you're thinking throw, but don't be shocked with this Cat offense if it's quarterback run game.
You got 5 wide, now 4 wide. Milan up the gut. Mazes his way through and moves the sticks.
Yeah, that was just straight quarterback lead. They motioned the tight end back into the backfield to run just a simple lead play for Tommy Malott. Now look at, if they continue this way, the style of playing, the clock is going to run out on them in the fourth quarter, I suspect. I think they've got to create some bigger plays through the pass game to actually win the game.
I think Coach Morningwig is voting for the Cats to throw a little more, Ben.
Please,
the vibe
throw
I'm getting.
The ball. Give your players every opportunity to actually win the game.
Play action, Malott.
Like that.
Wants to show off the arm. Deep threat. Incomplete. Through the hands, but a flag thrown. As that one was intended for Ty McCullough.
Well, I was watching this play develop in the secondary, and I think they might have a defensive hold.
Yeah. Yeah. But Cleveland Thomas just dropped that ball. That was a perfect pass.
Holding number 35 of the defense. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Yeah, you'd rather have the catch. I always used to tell the fellas, we want the catch. We don't want the hold. So keep fighting. Finish the play. That was a huge play, possibly a touchdown play, and if he uses his eyes and fingers all the way to the tuck to catch the ball.
And that's Braxton Hill. I mean, again, you get one-on-one matchups against linebackers. In theory, you know, your receivers should win those matchups. And I do love the way Braxton plays. Just got a little extra handsy there. Referee caught it.
Yeah, we highlighted him in the open. One of the top defensive players in the Big Sky leads this Grizz defense in tackles. First down and 10. Play fake again. Malott wants another deep shot and overthrows Ty McCullough.
Yeah, McCullough stopped just a little bit at the top of the route. Malott was trying to lead him more towards the sideline, and he just put the brakes on for some reason. Well, you got to fight through the tough coverage at the top of the route.
You bet, and it's great pressure from 48 Hayden Harris out of Mill Creek, Washington. UCLA transfer. He went to Eastside Catholic. He actually coached for one of my best friends, Coach Dom Dasty, who coached here at Montana. And oh, by the way, happy birthday, Coach Dom, big fella.
A lot. Shovels it. Pass midfield, Scottrey Humphrey.
What an absolutely awesome scrape play by 42 Riley Wilson out of Prosper, Texas. Coach called it earlier. I mean, what a rotation of backers these guys got right now. Watch this scrape, inside out angle, tracking that near hip, boom,
it wow. Like they had him out flight. But Wilson showed his speed on that play to prevent a bigger play.
Transfer out of the University of Hawaii. I'm enjoying watching this young man play football.
Third down, 6 to go. Lonergan in motion. Malott dancing. And well short of the first down marker to bring up fourth down.
Now Montana State should go for this.
I think they will, Coach.
Yep. By 20. Now look, the Grizz are keeping, they're playing assignment football. They're keeping their leverage. Look at Braxton Hill keeping leverage outside in. You saw Fouts there in the mix as well. Just as a leverage man, they're playing assignment football very, very well against this Montana State Bobcat offense that typically puts 40 or 50 points up on their opponent.
Well, again, you can see why they're the top rushing defense in the Big Sky this season. Fourth in the entire FCS, fourth and five. Four wide for the Bobcats. Milan goes to the air, floats it up. Incomplete. Trying to go to Ryan Lonergan.
Well, Ryan sort of calmed that route down too. You got to dig against tight coverage at the top of routes. And maybe he was looking for sort of a back shoulder throw, and Tommy threw it one-on-one down the field. They've got to complete some of those one-on-ones. They just haven't been able to do it except one time.
Montana State 0-for-3 on fourth downs today. The Grizz offense back on the field, up 20.
Welcome back to Washington-Grizzly Stadium. And as this game wraps up, this obviously wraps up the regular season for the FCS. So let's go ahead and take a look at that playoff picture, which will be finalized tomorrow. So we'll go ahead and break this down. There's 11 automatic qualifiers in the FCS playoffs and 13 at-large bids. The top eight teams will receive a seed and a first-round bye next week as the playoffs get underway. Teams are paired according to geographical proximity, and of course this runs all the way to the national championship in Frisco, Texas on January 7th. And obviously, as we talked earlier, Furman, the number two seed in the country right now, fell earlier today. So this game right now is for all the Maulers to get that number two seed between Montana and Montana State and get home field advantage throughout. Guys?
Yeah, no question, Kyle. He mentioned getting that number two seed, having home field advantage in the playoffs on one side of the bracket all the way to Frisco. I mean, this game just got even more huge.
It is huge, and history has shown that. Those top seeds, when they got to come through your house to get there, a la North Dakota State, South Dakota State. I mean, it's a recipe, and it's worked.
To the screen game, Nick Osmo weaving his way to the 35.
That's a Montana State fire zone to the Grizzly offense's right side, and they just ran a free release wide route with Osmo, and you can see right here there's a long way to go for the Montana State Bobcat defense on that. Good quick decision by Gilman once again. Ball 1 foot in front of the numbers, just beautifully executed against the blitz.
17 yards there. The senior out of Portland.
I was just going to say, McDowell's been sharp, but the game plan has been really sharp for him. 13 of 17 for 163. He's completing almost 80% of his balls. It's a great job by the offensive coaches for the University of Montana.
Yeah, it is. And that was a false start on the Montana Grizzlies. Look, this is a 20-point game. So
prior to the snap, false start, number 14 of the offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So what are the Bobcats saying? You know, you got to say, look, 21 points wins this game, right? Let's get the first one and see what happens. Now, to do that, right, then your defense has to stand up and basically shut them out, right? And the first couple plays of the Bobcat D look pretty good, and then Montana just helped them with a false start, first and 15.
Out of the pistol, McDowell. Quick strike to Aaron Fonts. And a gain of one there on the quick throw.
Yeah, nice open field tackle there by Lavelle Price. You know, Fonts was just called for the penalty as a wide receiver having that false start.
Yeah, how many times, Ty, do you see a guy get a holding call or get a penalty and then come back and catch a touchdown or make the touchdown block, right? This game is about redemption just a little bit on occasion, isn't it?
Absolutely, and as Ben knows, after 2 years working together, I love to sometimes say, and absolutely redeem yourself. But that was only a 1 yard game.
Nick Osmo again on the screen.
Osmo getting a couple extra yards to put the Grizz in a manageable third and six type of situation, just right at the top of scoring range.
What a neat young guy he must be, too. I mean, the guy's made a lot of plays for the University of Montana over the years. You've got a stud freshman that, you know, takes over the reins, kind of beats you out, a great player. But man, when he gets his opportunities, he's fun to watch.
This guy's a tough runner, Osmo. He reminds me of Greg Eisman. Greg Eisman in 1982 for the Grizzlies.
Yeah, approaching the 500-yard mark this season. McDowell under pressure on third down. Off-balance throw. Once again, another connection to Junior Bergen. And the Grizz with another first down.
What? He drilled that one. He spotted it. Dead on target to Bergen on the run. Let's watch him. He gets flushed to his right. That's a front door escape. Bam! Where's the ball? Right down the sternum. A beautifully thrown ball with a little juice on it from McDowell.
Great, great throw, and I think the guy got a little lucky because they're holding on to that fella from Melstone that I was telling you about in the open. I mean, Brody's got such great get off, and he's so active with his hands. They got to hold him, and I think they might have got away with one. Nice play by Cliff McDowell, though.
The fifth catch today, McDowell looking. Just has to throw it away.
That should be a lineman down the field again. It doesn't look like they're calling it. That was a slow screen again. Coach Vegan should be telling him the lineman down. He is. Coach Vegan's telling the official. Lineman down the field. That's twice that the Grizz have got away with that. The Bobcat defense is all over the Montana screen game today. That's one of the few things they've done really well.
Back to Bergen, flips it to Osmo. And Osmo out of bounds at around the 20.
Yeah, so that play is designed for the secondary to overreact to the first pass, and then you pitch it outside and you get a lane down the sideline for a big player or a score in Montana State. He smelt it a little bit and kept outside leverage. Officials timeout.
Again, we talk so much about the balance of this Montana offense. I mean, you look at the numbers, 225 pass yards, 90 on the ground. So they're really letting it fly through the air this afternoon. Clifton McDowell.
Really smart coming out from the get-go and throwing the ball a little bit more than they're accustomed to. Why? Because of the Bobcat defense. And they've kind of made the Bobcat defense sort of ordinary by scoring 27 points already in this ball game.
So now at the 20, Montana, a perfect 4-for-4 in the red zone today. Looking to make it 5-for-5. McDowell, up the gut. Tripped up inside the 10.
Just a basic quarterback draw out of empty. Now, I thought Montana State was going to run smack into it because they had a nice little game. But McDowell's speed just ran right by the looper coming inside.
Yeah, it's a great play call. And Ben Seymour's actually right there. It's just, athlete to athlete. You got a 285-pound young man trying to stop that guy. Nice little zip and zap by the wide receiver. It pulls those linebackers out of the middle of the defense. That's hard.
Yeah, McDowell, his mobility, his running ability has really made some hay today.
Aaron Fonts lost it on the turf, but able to recover and picks it back up. Hurdles another defender and pushed out of bounds by Daniel Louis LaCapa. Boy, that could have been disastrous for Montana.
Yeah, they've worked that for quite a while now. Fonts is coming off of an injury and hasn't practiced full speed until very recently. So ball security sometimes is an issue with a fella, a skilled guy, coming off the IR, so to speak. And you have to really emphasize the ball security to a man that's been hurt and playing his first game in a while.
Well, he did a heck of a job hurling John Johnson there. Nice pop. So Danny Yu, really good inside linebacker for that Montana State defense, also a captain. He's been out coach since Sacramento State.
After the play, personal foul, unsportsmanlike, late hit out of bounds, number 26 of the offense, 15-yard penalty, second down.
Nick Osmo.
That was Osmo. I'd like to see if we got any film on that, because Osmo's a smart player. He's a smart player. But he does hustle, he does finish. So it might have been just a little bit late right there.
Yeah, you can see right at the door, he's like, hold on now, which 26 we talking about? I wasn't even close there.
Yeah. I was about to say the same thing. You saw him on the screen, he's like, no, the other 26, right?
No, that's a big penalty, because now the Grizz are second and 28 from the 28.
screen draw situation right here. It is second and forever.
You know, after one of those, Bobby Houck is probably telling his sideline, hey, stay aggressive. Stay aggressive. Keep playing with passion.
Under 90 ticks left here in the third quarter. McDowell buying some time and taken down by Brody Grebe.
Brody's just waiting his time, man. I mean, he's kind of had a couple brief conversations with the refs saying, excuse me, sir, watch this play. I'm going to get a great get off. Watch him hold me. Nice job by him. Finally getting that tackle for loss. I mean, he is an effort dude. He plays the game the way it's supposed to be played.
Great coverage by the Bobcat secondary, which allowed him to make that play fantastic. Third and extra long. You would suspect, don't be surprised if Montana does something here just to make it an easier field goal. Don't be surprised by a running play here.
Yep, they'll keep it on the ground. McDowell, the keeper, trying to get the edge and knocked out of bounds.
They made it a much easier field goal with that run by McDowell.
Well, it's all about leverage and contain, coach. You said it a few plays ago. And watch when we see the replay here. Andrew Powdrow, the youngster out of the Woodlands, Texas, number one, he gets out leveraged. He's got to get this ball knocked back to his buddies so that Rylan Orr can make the play. He does not. Like you said, should be a chip shot field goal for Montana.
Nice blocking by the Grizzlies' offensive line. They've really come into their own late in this. About midseason, they really started playing fantastic.
28-yarder for Ramos after that 20-yard run by Clifton McDowell. And another flag thrown.
Well, to your point, Coach, it was that NAU game, I think, right, where the guys like Chad Germer and Fendog Rob Fennessy looked at that offensive line and said, hey, we got to do better. And they have.
Yeah, they widen the splits. They use more vertical first and second steps. There's a lot of things that were going on. But those men that are playing on the offensive line, they allow those men to use their physicality just a little bit more.
Running into the kicker, 5-yard penalty has been declined. Score is good.
Just dumb errors, though. In a game of this magnitude, running into the kicker, you know, the false starts, you know, this is for the number two seed in the country, which means you get home field advantage throughout. You gotta be smart, and that's back-to-back plays. I don't mean to call the young man out, but you gotta set an edge for your defense, and you gotta be smart on special teams.
Desperately trying to block the kick, and sometimes it blows up on you, but it's rarely back-to-back. Now look, that field goal made it more than a 21-point game. So don't be surprised if Montana State scores. They start going for two. Because it's going to be very difficult to get more than three touchdowns on this Montana Grizz defense.
And again, going for that number two seed, you see the playoff resume for Bobby Houck's squad, 9-1 coming into this Brawl of the Wild, 8-1. Yeah, outside of that Northern Arizona game, it's been a tremendous Big Sky season for the Grizz.
Well, in NAU, historically, always plays better at 7,000 feet in the friendly confines of the walk-up Sky Dome. You know, you and I got to witness them firsthand.
Yep.
And it didn't even look like the same outfit that you and I were watching in Ogden before the Weber State game.
And meanwhile, for Montana State, I mean, you got those two losses against top 10 foes at South Dakota State, at Idaho. You got some wins, too. At the time, a top 10 opponent in Weber State and Sac State, 10th in the country in strength of schedule. But a long way to go, a lot of work to be done for Tommy Mallott.
Boy, how about Weber State, who just looks like they're dead to rights, their season's over, and then they go off last week and knock off an excellent Idaho football team.
To set up this huge game.
Yes.
Julius Davis looking for a window. And a gain of two on that run. As that will end the third quarter here in Missoula. Yeah, looking to make it 74 wins in this rivalry. 30-7. Montana looking for their first Big Sky title in over a decade. Time to take a look at today's game summary brought to you by Achieve Montana College Savings for their future. You see Montana State 1 of 7 on third downs, but it has been the Grizzly offense really producing in front of the Grizz faithful here at Washington-Grizzly Stadium, 15 minutes away from their first Big Sky title since 2009 as we get the fourth quarter underway. Second and 8, Tommy Malott drops back with a strike to Cleveland Thomas and brought down at the 39.
A flag in the backfield. It's either roughing the passer or a hold, one of the two.
Yeah, it looks like we're coming back.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, number 35 in the defense.
Maybe not.
15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the play, first down.
Well, I've said it all game. I love the way Braxton Hill plays football, but he's also got to play smart football. That's a big penalty, moving the ball across midfield.
Yeah, it gives Montana State a little juice here. Let's see. Grab him around the helmet. But Big Ben, I'll tell you, they're 23 points down. So Montana State should be in 2-minute offense the rest of the game because they need 3 touchdowns and a couple 2-point plays to get this thing back to even, right?
Yeah, you think they'd go to that because Tommy Malott, Brent Vegan has said, this offense, they've been good in 2-minute drill situations this season, as we'll get a flag before the snap. False start.
I tell you, I don't know what was seen on TV, but offensively, they're trying to sprint Taco Dallar out.
False start. Number 72, the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Defensively, the Grizz are sprinting Ryan Terrell out, so each side doesn't have 12 guys on the field. It's just, it's a big game. You gotta be smart.
Yeah, communication comes into play big time when it's loud, especially when you're on the road and it's loud and it's a big game. Trust and communication goes a long way.
Bouncing to the outside. The rip down at midfield. Riley Wilson again with the stop.
Riley Wilson says no. It not happening on my football field. Now, again, Montana State needs to play fast here. You can see Riley Wilson right there. What a sure tackler. These, all of them on the Montana Grizz defense have become this year.
Well, he's trying to say, hey, I didn't rough him up that bad. It's still football. You got to go play football. And this kid plays the game the way it should be played. Love watching him.
Pressure coming from behind. Malott lets it fly. Incomplete. Trying to find Cleveland Thomas.
Yeah, good one-on-one coverage. Once again, it's a lot of one-on-one covers. That was against Jackson in the secondary. Look at Montana State has thrown 4 or 5 balls down the field one-on-one. They've got like none. Tommy Malott is now 2 for 8. Now one of them was a touchdown down in their red zone, but they've got to complete some of those down the field throws.
Yeah, now 2 for 9 in the passing game today. Only 32 yards through the air for Montana State. On third down, Malott will use his legs. Trying to turn the corner. Cuts back inside. And stops short of the 40.
Against the normal defense, that was likely a first down with Malott's speed. But Braxton Hill says, nope, I'm going to track you, and I'm going to take a good angle. Look at this angle that he takes. That is just... perfect.
Well, we keep talking about these Grizz linebackers. I'd be hard-pressed not to mention their coach, Roger Cooper, who was an All-American linebacker for the Montana State Bobcats.
Fourth down. Montana State's got to go for it. Oh for 3 today. Pressure coming underneath. Complete.
Gentlemen,
it looks like it might be well short.
I think he's short.
That's a yard short.
Yep.
Montana did a great job of coverage and sure tackling. Montana State ran a shallow cross against man-to-man, and they were anticipating a catch and a run.
No, it's a good read by Tommy. He knows he's got to get the ball out quickly. They're sending 6-man man pressure to your point, coach. Great coverage. That's a takeaway. That's a fourth down stop. Defensively, that's a takeaway.
And now the Grizzlies have excellent field position at, what, their own 44, Ben?
Well, again, you talk about the defense for Montana, now 0 for 4 against Montana State. 1 of 8 on third down, allowing to the Bobcats. Eli Gilman leaps ahead.
No, you just said it, Ben. They are 1 of 12 on third and fourth down in the 122nd Brawl of the Wild.
You're not going to beat anybody doing that. So it's one of those games, much like we were talking about Montana laying the big egg right in the middle of the 50-yard line at NAU.
Yep.
Now that team was going to go one of two ways, right? And because of the great leadership, their coaching staff, the players, the toughness, the mental toughness, they skyrocketed out of that and got better and better and better every week. Now Montana State was similar up until this ball game.
That's something we were talking about at your gorgeous house last night, Coacher. Just the dominance of the home team the last few games, right? 21, 22, 23. My goodness, just dominant performances by the home squad.
Yeah, every home team for the last three times. Now it looks like it's going to be the fourth time in a row. That home field advantage, I think, might be a bigger influence on the game than it was in the past.
Oh, shoot, there was a string there where the road team was actually winning more than the home team. I mean, I know this because I was a part of them, getting to coach in 15 of these. But, yeah, it's been all the home team as of late.
But I will tell you, when I was playing, we were playing at Dorm Blazer, which I thought was kind of, in a funny way, a reverse home field advantage. But then playing Montana State, felt like you had to bust through the dirt and the gravel to get to a field out in a field.
McDowell up the gut to the 40.
And now, Ben, these two stadiums are like beautiful. The Washington-Grizz Stadium, by the way, thank you, the Washington family. Is this a sight to behold right here in Missoula, Montana at the Washington-Grizz? Dennis Washington built this stadium many years ago.
No question. I mean, both venues right here in Missoula in Bozeman, two terrific settings for FCS football.
Yeah, and over 27,000 fans today. I mean, there's FBS programs that wish they could get that. Shoot, turn on Maction on a Tuesday or Wednesday.
Yeah, this might go against Montana State. This will be interesting for Coach Houck, the winningest Big Sky coach in history, the Big Sky history. Will they go for a fourth and one if it's against Montana State, or will they go ahead and punt it, or possible fake punt?
Offside defense, number 32. 5-yard penalty, it's still fourth down.
Fourth and one. He might be putting a fake on, but looks like he's keeping his punt team out there. So it's either going to be a fake for one, you know, trying to gain 1 yard, or they're just going to try to pin him once again down inside the 10-yard line.
Yeah, but if everything was on the line, again, another foolish penalty by the guys in white. I think he's just going to punt it. He's going to start playing really slow football and trying to eat up that clock and get out of here with a victory.
Oh,
Dollar lost it. Scramble for the ball. And it will be Grizz football inside the five.
Obviously, there's 10 minutes left in this ball game, gentlemen, but this thing's over. One team showed up to win the Big Sky Championship and one did not. I don't know how else to say it.
You're calling it a night. The party's over.
I mean, a lot can happen in 10 minutes, but I mean, I'm not the smartest guy in the world, Coach, but I'm not a complete idiot either.
All good things must come to an end.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm agreeing with you. Turn out the lights. The party's over for the Bobcats. Now, where do they go from here? Where do the Bobcats go from here? They better be mentally prepared for the playoffs.
Grizz football when we come back.
Today's game is sponsored by Montana State University, Mountains and Mines, Town Pump, Pump It Up, Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking, your Montana Chevy dealers, and the University of Montana. Our mission is Montana.
They've been doing this now for 122 times. Montana State with the football inside the five, up the window. And getting to around the 8-yard line.
Gubner again, reckon, have penetrating, making the back cut back too quickly, and other Montana Grizzlies in there for the tackle.
This is the problem, though, Coach. You kind of been alluding to it all game. When you don't have the ability to throw the football, I get that they're backed up a little bit. They want to get that ball out of the end zone just a little bit, but you've also just used a minute of play clock.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if you lose by 50 or if you lose by one. Give your team an opportunity to actually win the ball game. And the Bobcats really aren't doing that by running the ball back to back.
Julius Davis again with the carry and picks up a first down. You know, I'm going to bring up a point here. We talked about it last year when we were on the call in Missoula. I mean, you go back to that game, Montana State had 439 yards on the ground when we hiked up this Montana defense, and especially that rush defense. I mean, it's been almost a complete 180 here in 2023.
You're exactly right, Ben. You know who deserves a lot of credit? That's defensive coordinator Ronnie Bradford and a defensive analyst by the name of Tim Houck.
Milan with a lot of time in the pocket.
Little slot fade, that finally got one.
That one hauled in by Taco Dowler. What a catch.
Taco.
It really was, because he's kind of looking up, and that, you know, that sun's finally starting to creep out 2.5 hours later. What a catch by the young man out of Billings, Montana.
Bobcats are trying to play fast, get themselves. You know, I remember there was a game in 2010. The Miracle in the Meadowlands, number two. We were down 21 points with 8 minutes left and won the game.
30-yard completion to Taco Dowler. Over 8 minutes to go. Off-balance throw from Milan. And just out of the reach of Ryan Lonergan.
Just a little high. Ty, you ever have one of those great backs?
Shoot, I mean, Coach, the last time I coached in this stadium, 2018, we're down by 19 points. We stopped the Grizzly offense at the one-yard line, and they made a dang documentary on it called The Miracle in Missoula, you know, so anything can happen. I mean there's right. It's just 23 points, you know, with the new rule. When you get first downs, it doesn't stop the clock. They got to play fast.
With the defender all over that tight end, Tommy should have thrown the ball lower so the receiver could go down and get the ball.
Milan looking to make something happen. Still trying to buy time. Finally throws on the run. And that one picked off.
Bradney. What a play, Ben.
His fifth INT this season.
It's just that type of day, Ben. I'm sorry to cut you out, but I mean, you know, Tommy's trying to, he's trying, right? He's trying. He's scrambling, throwing across his body. Probably an ill-advised throw, but he's trying. He's trying to win the game.
Hey, we've been through it. The Bobcats are playing hard. They're just not playing very good.
Want to appreciate all of you and thank all of you for sending your photos into the hashtag MMA Fan Zone. And I apologize to those kids. Probably not an exciting birthday bash. All the way from Australia, a couple Bobcat fans rooting on their team. And certainly a happy household there all the way in Texas. And another house divided in Billings. And, you know, one of them is having a good day. All decked out in maroon and silver.
Ooh.
Again, big thanks to all of you for sending in your photos. Nick Osmo with the carry on this first play of this series for Montana as we continue to wind down this one.
Physical dude, this Osmo character. This man goes downhill and breaks tackles. So for the Bobcats, you just hang in there. It could be a big play by your own team. Could be a big mistake by the Grizzlies. Could be an official's call. Could be the bounce of the ball. But something has to spur you to even have any chance at all of getting back in this game. Now Ty and I, we already called it. So the Grizz fans are already lighting their cigars up like Red Auerbach and, you know, pulling out the ice cream out of the freezer for the kids.
Yeah, if you're Nick Saban or Joe Burrow, you can light cigars after games, but not at Ferris State. If you're at Ferris State, you can't smoke the big
cigar. Nick Osmo turning on the Jets. And the senior is gone for six, and that's the dagger.
What a great thing for Nick Osmo. He pops off a big one in the 2023 Brawl of the Wild, in his last Brawl of the Wild. That's a pretty, what a memory that's going to be for that young man.
64 yards to the end zone.
Nice job by the offensive line. It looks like Montana State has kind of folded the tent and looking forward to the playoffs with a little bit lower seed than they wanted.
Coach, they're folding the tent. I don't know when they set the tent up. It's just been that kind of day. Again, well, one team came to compete for a championship, one did not. I don't know how else to say it.
They tried to set the tent up in the early third quarter, but they didn't quite get it set.
Breezy, a little windy, they couldn't get it set up. It's just, it is what it is.
Look at that dude fly, Nick Osmo for six. 30-point lead for the third-ranked Grizz. Well, Nick Osmo all the way to the house, and now a 30-point lead for Montana. You see the numbers there. 85 yards today, and a couple of receptions for the senior. And like Marty mentioned, I mean, getting a big play like this in your final Brawl of the Wild, I mean, that's going to be a memory that's going to live with him forever.
He just stamped. I saw some of those players in the background pointing to the ring finger. He just stamped a Big Sky championship ring for all the fellas on the Grizz sideline. You either are a Big Sky champion or you're not.
Here's Marquise Johnson taking it out of the end zone. And Johnson to the 30. Yeah, Marty, I know you said it earlier, but you had to sing it when you said, you know, turn out the lights, the party's over.
That was bad. That was good. You sound like Monday Night Football decades ago. I love it.
I tell you, if I had my druthers, neither of you would sing again.
Would even try.
No, that's the only time you will ever hear me sing, on air or off air.
I'm having a good time. I hope you guys are too.
Always great to call the games with you guys. Julius Davis, short of the 35.
Yeah, this is white flag. You bring in Big Sean Chambers, who you've seen very little, who's a flat difference maker for this Bobcat offense, and they're running read zone. It's white flag time. Yeah. Also a song by Dido. Go ahead, Coach.
Well, Chambers didn't get in the game because they didn't have many plays because they couldn't get a convert even on a third down throughout the game. So here comes Chambers. He might add a little spark towards the end of the game, but this Grizz defense, they're bowing up. They ain't gonna give him anything for free.
Yeah, 276 total yards for Montana State this afternoon. Chambers looking to make something happen. And another tackle for loss by this Grizz front.
I'll tell you that.
And going back to that INT from Tommy Mellott, how about that? His first interception thrown in 223 pass attempts. You got to go to all the way to that crazy Weber State game in Bozeman last year, the last time that happened.
Well, it's a great stat. You can just tell. I mean, like I said, he's trying to win, you know, finish the game. He's pressing while he's doing so. Ill-advised throw. Nice job by the secondary.
Third and eight, Chambers under pressure.
The Grizz, they're not going to get many. That was a zero blitz plus one, single coverage with no help everywhere on the field. They're forcing the Montana State Bobcats down by what, 30 to punt the football with less than 6 minutes left going on five.
And what's cool, the way both those series ended, offense, defensively, we're talking about seniors. Seniors playing in their last Brawl, in Levi Giancaro, you know, the legacy number 37. Got to work with 37s, and Craig Paulson, Tim Houck, got to coach a lot of great 37s. What an honor it is to wear that jersey if you're a Montana Grizzly.
Fair catch call by Junior Bergen. Over 5 minutes left in this one, but the celebration beginning here in Missoula. Yeah, the sun's starting to shine here at Washington-Grizzly Stadium. Les Schwab scoreboard 37-7. Montana in tie. We were talking about this. Now this will be the fourth consecutive meeting where basically the home team has absolutely dominated in this rivalry.
Well, and even in 2021, Coach Vegan's first experience to Missoula, it really wasn't as close as that score indicates. But yeah, the home team has kind of taken the other to the outside the woodshed the last few Brawls. There's no doubt about it.
Ayotte in at the quarterback spot. This is great experience for Ayotte because next year, if he's the guy, and it certainly looks like he's going to be, then he's not a rookie playing in this game. He's had real experience in the Brawl of the Wild.
Well, again, he's shown flashes at times this season for Montana.
Yeah, big time. I mean, this guy's got it all. Now, he's learned. He's made a couple mistakes, but as long as you learn from those mistakes and, you know, it doesn't happen again, then that's how guys really grow fast at the quarterback position.
Good shot of Coach Green there, another one of the many alumni on Coach Houck's staff.
He's a heck of a running back coach as well. Now, that might not be a good play to say this, but all his backs get extra yards on a consistent basis.
Let's take a look at our AVA Law Group Red Zone recap. And again, Montana has been absolutely solid in that category today. A perfect 5 for 5 for that Montana offense, as opposed to 1 for 2 for Montana State.
You know, talking about red zone statistics, the actual red zone statistic doesn't correlate as highly to winning as how many times you get down there. Because why? When you get down there, you're normally scoring points in some regard, either a touchdown or a field goal.
Another give to Isaiah Childs. Now bring up a fourth down.
Well, what I'm going to be interested to see, obviously Montana, not obvious, but Montana will probably be getting that number 2 seed. They say, the pundits, the prognosticators, whatever the word is, they say that Montana State, you know, whichever team was going to lose this game was probably a top 8 seed as well, meaning you get that first round bye. What I'm going to be curious to see is how well this Bobcat outfit responds after this, because they haven't taken one on the chin like this for quite some time.
Yeah, this one's on the chin. You know, it's 37-7. Does that score influence any of the seedings? I doubt it.
Dowler will haul it in at around the 17, and he'll get to the 20. With under 3 minutes to play. And time to take a look at our Town Pump offensive player of the game. Definitely Clifton McDowell. How about this? 17 of 22 through the air for 200 yards. And right now the second leading rusher today for the Grizz with 69.
Clifton McDowell has become a superstar quarterback for the Montana Grizzlies. And that's a very difficult thing to do with only having 2/3 of a season to actually play the quarterback position. The man is undefeated as a starter for the Grizzlies.
Yeah, again, it's something we mentioned at the top of the broadcast. Ever since he was given full reins of this Grizzly offense, I mean, they've been absolutely clicking.
Yeah, I've been through it. Sometimes when you give the quarterback the starting job, go, look, you're the guy, right? Then they take the bull by the horns and they don't let go, and they do a great job of leading, right? When you don't make a man your starter, he may be a little bashful to do those type of things. And I'm talking about leading a team to win after win after win.
Chambers, a strike to the far side, incomplete. Trying to go to Cleveland Thomas. You know, Ty, I want to bring up that point again. You mentioned, look, Montana State's still going to go to the playoffs. They're going to still have their season extend. But really, how do you bounce back from a game like this heading into the postseason?
Well, it's going to help because they're going to be in Bozeman.
Right.
That's almost guaranteed that they'll be back in Bozeman, which the friendly confines of Bobcat Stadium have been awfully good, as you know. Brent Vegan's never lost at home. They've got the longest win streak in all of football going on currently. But yeah, it's going to take some good coaching, some good playing, you know, just to look each other in the eye and point the thumbs back in, because all of it played a part in this loss today.
Another underthrown ball.
It's not looking any better either. You know, I mean, they got to be mentally tough too, right? Okay, that one's gone. What's the next mission, right? What's the next mission? And then I suspect once they put the film on, some of the guys were trying to do a little too much, likely, and trying to make the great play to win the game. Do your job and do it within the realm of the game plan.
Well, and you know, the bulk of this staff's now been here twice, and they didn't perform well either time. I mean, there's only a couple new coaches on the staff this year that didn't come with Coach Vegan 2 years ago. And they got to either, you know, reevaluate or adjust some things that are happening in the 6 days prior to this game.
So now we take a look at the Town Pump defensive player of the game. And with Braxton Hill, you see the embrace there by Bobby Houck.
Braxton Hill Everything goes through him on the Grizz defense. I'll tell you, Gubner wrecked havoc back there. Wilson was all over the place. There were many others that made sure tackles in the open field for the Grizz defense, and that was one of the pluses that made the score so out of whack. And we got a new quarterback in, Chris Brown.
Yeah, the leading tackler this season for Montana. Childs bouncing to the outside, turning the corner. And gets hit. Yeah, past the 50, but a flag and thrown at the 40.
It's going to come back, Ben. They're going to have a holding call here on Zach Cruz, a Missoula guy. It's funny because Chris Brown comes in the game from Bozeman, Montana, and they held the young man from Missoula.
Zach Cruz was in my quarterback school a few years back at Sentinel High School. He's a defensive end type of fella, but Dane Oliver was going to play him at quarterback because he was just the best athlete on the field. And he's really, we talked about him with the Montana State coaches. This man is developing into a monster of a defensive end. And he also has great athleticism. I would have taken him as a quarterback and given him a year or two at quarterback. And then if it didn't work, then move him, because this guy could play many different positions.
Again, keeping it on the ground, trying to lead the rest of this clock with under 2 minutes to go. The celebration, like I said, already underway. And, you know, going back to Braxton Hill, as you see the embrace there from Bobby Houck, you know, a really good soundbite from the Grizz head coach came a couple of weeks ago when talking about Braxton Hill. He told a couple of his friends that Braxton Hill had a bright future way back when he first started here in Missoula. And a lot of them thought Houck was kind of crazy, but you look what Braxton Hill's been able to do in his time here in Missoula. Absolutely is grinded to get to where he is today.
You saw Seth Monner, the president of the University of Montana. He's on the sideline with Bobby Houck congratulating him, the president of the university. That's how big this game is.
Childs again with the rock.
Seth Monner, he's got to be really, really happy. Ken Haslam, the athletic director at the University of Montana, really, really happy with this big win. And there's McDowell. He's become like an icon here in Missoula, even though he called it the battle for the brawl.
Yep.
You know, I thought they would have t-shirts out there.
I think he knows what it's called now.
Battle for the brawl of the brawl. There should be t-shirts.
But you were talking about the president. You're talking about the AD. How about that guy they keep showing, Bobby Houck? His first run in the first 7 years, he was 5-2, hasn't been as successful in his return stint. But my goodness. A Big Sky championship now and a top seed. Wow, what a job by him.
Yeah, he hasn't been as successful in his second stint yet up to now, and now he wins a Big Sky championship, likely the number two seed in the playoffs.
Yeah, you see the Gatorade bath there on Bobby Houck. Yeah, it was 2 months ago that loss to NAU. There was a lot of doubt, but it is going to be mayhem in Missoula tonight. A 30-point win for the third-ranked Grizz for the first time since 2009. Montana are the Big Sky champions.
Yeah, like I was saying, just a wonderful job by Coach Houck and staff. You know, a lot of his staff are Grizz alum. You know, a handful of them. And you can see the big offensive lineman. That's kind of a tradition at both schools. You get your big fellas up front to go pick up over 300 pounds and walk it around, parade it around the stadium and enjoy and savor every second of it.
Yeah, they'll be celebrating for about 24 hours. Hey, some of those institutions down in Missoula, they're gonna make a little bit more money out there.
Let's go down to Kyle Hansen.
All right, hey guys, I'm with Bobby Houck and Clifton McDowell. And
you talk to the big guy here after me.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Battle of the Brawl, you guys are Big Sky champions again. Just how does that sound right now?
The old Battle of the Brawl, whatever they call it, I know they call it an ass kicking is what they call it.
Big Sky champions again. Just walk us through what it's like in this game. Cliff, you were a huge part of this. How did it feel?
It felt amazing. I mean, that was a great team. Shout out to Montana State coming in here and competing, but it felt nice getting the dub. So you got to keep stacking.
You guys, just that first half offense, you had that 14-play drive right off the bat. Just what was clicking for you guys on the offensive side? Yeah.
That was good. Good job, kid. We're going on.
Just walk us through the offensive game, Cliff.
Oh, we knew we just had to put points on them. and put them in position where they had to come back, because we know they were the run-heavy offense, so we know we just had to put points on the board.
You guys, that second half kind of stayed with it, and then Nick Osmo had that play. We got Braxton Hill here as well. Just what was it like watching Nick Osmo take that to the house and seal this one?
Hey, man, I loved it. I loved it. I was running down the sideline, waving at their sideline, telling them it's over. So just glad to send them back home and got the trophy back.
You guys are Big Sky champions. You're likely going to be a 2-seed in the playoffs. Just how does that sound to you from everything you guys have been through this year?
Yeah, I'm proud of this team, how we overcame adversity, and the resiliency we showed this season. And I'm glad that we was able to come back with the Big Sky Conference Championship.
Go celebrate, Cliff. Appreciate your time. Cool. Congratulations. We're going to bring in Braxton Hill now. What a scene we've got here down here for the Grizzlies to get this one back. And we have a Captain Braxton Hill, Anaconda, Montana, right here. Just Braxton, walk us through these emotions to get this win.
Oh, I'm feeling awesome, man. I mean, ever since I've been a freshman, Coach Ox been saying championships. We've been saying working on 19. You know, it's been 6 years, and I'm just proud of these seniors. I'm proud of this team. It's a special feeling, man.
You guys, defensively, you guys were on it kind of from the get-go. The two huge stops in the first half. Just walk us through getting those stops and how big that was for you guys, especially going into halftime.
Oh, it was huge. This team was locked in all week. You know, Coach Bradford and the rest of the coaches, we had a great game plan. And I have never seen such a focused and determined group throughout the week, man. We were ready to play this game.
You know, walk me through Trevin Gratney's interception as well right there. That felt like it sealed it, and then Nick had the touchdown. Just what can you say about Trevin's play there?
Oh, Trev's the man. Billings native. He's a Montana kid. I love that dude. He works his butt off. And, you know, it was a scramble drill. And I looked back, and I saw Trev coming, and he picked it. And then Nick's run was awesome. Nick's a heck of a dude, heck of a player. And, you know, moments like that I'll never forget.
You guys are Big Sky champions once again. You're likely going to be the 2-seed in the playoffs. Just how does that sound to you after the season you guys have had?
Sounds like everything, man. Sounds great.
Awesome. Go celebrate, Braxton. Appreciate your time. We'll send it back upstairs, guys. Thank you.
All right, Kyle. Appreciate it. Yeah, big game, big season for Braxton Hill. And, you know, something we talked about, guys, the offense for Montana. They came in over the last six games averaging 441 yards per game. They got a little short of that at 430, but once again, I mean, there's a reason they've now won seven straight, and they're now the Big Sky champions. With Clifton McDowell and this offense clicking, they've been hard to stop.
Yeah, they threw for 228 yards and rushed for 202 yards. What an offensive output by Brent Peace, offensive coordinator. The rest of us, they got a great staff, and Bobby Houck, led by Clifton McDowell.
Yeah, and anytime you see 37-7, a 30-point victory, everyone's going to highlight the offense. But my goodness, how about that defense for the Grizz? I mean, wow. I mean, those linebackers fly around. Big Governor, he takes up two blocks. I mean, that defense is playing lights out. And just getting to watch them throughout the year and the way they zip and zap. And I've already given compliments to Coach Ronnie Bradford, Tim Houck, Roger Cooper. These guys have put together a heck of a defense. These guys play hard, they play fast, they play sound. They are fun to watch. And with a defense like that, that is what can take you on a long playoff slash potential championship run.
They've given up 24 points in the last four ball games.
Outstanding.
Yeah, it's just an outstanding. Now, their defense has been really, really good all year long. Their offense has really come to play, and their offense has gotten better and better every week, and you can see by Clifton McDowell throwing for, he threw for 200 because Ayak threw for four. And then Racanelli, the lefty, he was one for 24 on the trick play.
So again, conference champs for Montana. You look at the updated standings in the Big Sky. Of course, the Montana Grizzlies, the Big Sky champions at 7-1. Montana State drops to 6-2. Still a couple games to be played today, including with Idaho and Sacramento State. And you see the celebration beginning. Bobby Houck holding up that Big Sky Champions trophy being hoisted up. You know he's going to enjoy this one.
Well, I've known Coach Houck since I was 16 years old, guys. He recruited me to the University of Colorado. I got to work with him at the University of Washington for 2 years. He gave me my first full-time gig right here 20 years ago, all right? And it's awesome to see. And listen, the games they remember are played in November. And you want to see teams get better and better and better throughout the year? That's exactly what this team did here in Missoula. And not every team can say they just continued to get better and finally got in their groove. This team's in the groove.
and playing excellent football. Great job by the Montana coaching staff, but more importantly, an outstanding job by the Grizzly players and their focus within this game, because you can get out of focus real easy in a game like this. It looked like Montana State was a little out of focus. Now where do you go? You're right. Now the playoffs. So the Grizz are Big Sky Conference champions. But now the playoffs, that's a single elimination tournament. Just get yourself in. Now the Grizz have the number two seed, which favors them mightily. But the Montana State Bobcats, there's no doubt that they have the ability to make a run in the playoffs.
Oh, Coach, you've seen it. I mean, you've seen Montana State go toe for toe with the number one team in Brookings, South Dakota, in South Dakota State. You saw it. I mean, it really, I'd never say this. They should have won the game. 9 false starts is not going to let you win against a poor team, let alone against a great team. So you know they're capable. They just got to put it, they got to refocus. Like I said, they kind of got to look in the mirror and come back in 2 weeks and take, you know, freshen up a little bit, get some dudes back, enjoy a little bit of Thanksgiving, and come back, because it's a whole new season. Anybody, you know, you've coached in a lot of, you know, college, pro. You make the playoffs, it's anyone's game, you know. And like I said about Montana, though, they're playing as good, if not better than anybody in the country.
Montana State better fix their third downs. The 1-for-10 and 0-for-4 on fourth downs.
Yeah, you see the Great Divide Trophy returns to Missoula. 37-7, the final for number 3 Montana over number 4 Montana State. For Ty Gregorek, Marty Morningwig, Scott Breen, Kyle Hansen, and the rest of our terrific Scripps Sports crew, I'm Ben Crane, saying so long from Washington Grizzly Stadium, where Bobby Houck and the Montana Grizzlies are your Big Sky champions of 2023. So long, everyone.